What's up? This is the Sneaker Box Podcast with Sneaker Bar Detroit. I am the African Caesar. I'm here with my man Skully and Guru. What's up?
Yo,
I'm good.
Everybody feeling good?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we good.
Morning starting off kind of shitty, but we'll
I gotta give you my move for the day. Give you my move for the day right now. You ready?
Yep.
It's gonna take you back a little bit, Caesar.
Oh, they're gonna music.
No time for fake ones. Just sip some Cristal with these
Guru's literally over here dancing like Diddy. Minus the shiny suit.
Yeah. And while you keep talking, wish we count bank funds. I got no time for fake ones. Just sip some Cristal with these real ones.
Somebody's having fun.
That's,
right?
That's the move right now.
I'm glad somebody's having fun. All right, so yeah, this is a Sneaker Box Podcast with Sneaker Bar Detroit, sponsored by Grace Brand. There's a time and place for everything, and that includes sneakers. So if you're looking to step your game up and get your grown man on, go on to greats.com and check out the selection of premium casual and dress shoes. Real quick, I'm going to give a quick shout out to Juan. Just got married over the weekend.
Congrats, Juan.
Congrats to him. So he's down in Miami right now.
Yes, sir.
Working on making baby number one. So definitely shout out to him. MJ should be on the way here, but we'll try to hold it down with it because we all know the show. So there you go, round of applause for MJ. The show sucks without her. So anyway, got the hit list. Got the Nike Kobe Prelude Pack restock, the Distinct Life Special Edition Reebok GL 6000 mid camera, Nike Sportswear Air Max 95 Ultra Jacquard, Nike LeBron Soldier 8 Fly Ease. That's the shoe that they did for the people with disabilities, right?
Mm-hmm.
Got the Ewing 33 High, white and black. I actually like those. Air Jordan Retro 7 Bordeaux. Anybody get those? Anybody? I know you probably got like...
Yeah, of course.
Yeah. You don't sound too thrilled about it.
I mean, there was a lot of them out there, so it wasn't too exciting.
Now, how did they do in the store?
They did well. I know, like, the malls, like, they probably got a lot left. I know the Finish Line 12 Oaks had a couple pair left. And then the dude at Champs, because I went there looking for a size, he told me yesterday, they were getting sent size 8 to 9. So, I mean, they did well. I mean, Nike did what they wanted. We wanted y'all to do, flood them so everybody can get them.
Yeah.
So, they can't be complaining. It was good.
But they still sit in the stores, though. They didn't sell out.
Like, smaller sizes, yeah.
Okay.
That's a shoe that, like, come, like, September, October, it'll really be bought up, especially from people like
that's
me.
A fall shoe, yeah.
Yeah, just the colors, man, and what
I agree.
So.
I never was big on the Bordeaux anyway, so I mean,
that's one of my favorites, man.
Yeah,
I was an easy pass for me, so. I don't know, so somebody out there got a size 15.
I got one.
Did you? Send it to Andy. I don't even want it.
I already gave him his, so I got an extra one.
Oh, good. I don't even want it. I can't even muster up. Nah, I swear, I can't even muster up the excitement for that shoe.
They got Nike Air on the inside, too.
Oh, in that case. Give me two of them. Wings and Horns Special Edition Adidas Stan Smith, the Nike LeBron 12 EXT Prism Finisher Breakfast. I like those too. I'd probably get them for my daughter.
They ain't coming grade school, only men's.
What?
Oh, yeah. EXT's only men's.
Okay. Well, just learned something today. I got the Kendrick Lamar Special Edition Reebok Ventilator Neutral.
I got some of those coming tomorrow.
Do you?
Yeah.
All right, see it. I want to see them. I want to see what they look like.
That's the one with the red and the blue in the back here?
Yeah. Yeah.
How much are they going for?
Retail is $125. My price won't be that bad.
What?
I think about grabbing the pair. That's
like
why
two something. Yeah.
Real quick, somebody hit me up. I'm sorry, I know I'm diverting from the list, but somebody hit me up with the Bordeaux. Somebody hit me up with an offer for the Chicago ones, and everybody knows my stance on them. I'm not going lower than 260, or I'm not going higher than 260. I'm sorry. Anyway. Dude, like, wears them and everything, creased up, and he's like, he said 260. I'm like, I'm paying 260 for a desktop pair. I'm not paying 260 for a creased up pair. And then he's like, well, I only wore it once. And I'm like, it don't matter how many times you wore it if it looked that damaged. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's like me driving your car, and like, man, I was only driving it for 5 minutes, but it's like a scratch on the door. Yeah. It's like, it don't matter how long I was driving it.
Yeah, exactly.
It's the damage I did to it, so.
Man, you know, it's...
You're still not going to get them ones for less than
2 seconds. You see, yeah, I'm not pressed about it, though.
He's not. 300, I think you should. That's reasonable. Right.
I'm
reasonable.
Not doing it.
But this lady came in with her son. She bought some shoes. The very next day, brought them back. I mean, it's like dirt on the bottom, crease. Me being the person I am with shoes, the cush line on the KD7s were wrinkling, which means you had to apply a certain amount of pressure on it for it to start creasing on the midsole right before you get to the sole.
Right.
The air bubble bag was fogged up. You know, when you have to wear your shoes for a minute for the airbag to fall out. So he did this all in 24 hours. Then they were trying to convince me like they didn't wear the shoe. It's like, it's warm. We weren't. He tried in the house and he walked around the house and, you know, that was it. He didn't wear this shoe on the get up. I'm like, this shoe is. I said, would you buy this shoe? If we had this shoe on the shelf, would you buy this shoe?
No.
No, it's just like, come on. What I think happened is that he tried. Here's the thing. When he came back in there, he wanted a different pair. This is before I seen this shoe. So I'm like, what size you wear? He was like, 12. I said, well, what size you got on right now? 12. So I brought him out a 13 and the other KD, so these fit. The shoe he bought was an 11. So you knew, if you're already in a 12, why are you wearing an 11 in the KD? Right? That was the first fit. I didn't help him the day before, but I was analyzing that when right. he came in. So what I think happened is that his mama bought the shoes, whatever. His parents bought the shoes, and then... He wore them without them knowing, and then when they hurt his feet, he put them back in the box, and he's like, oh, man, these shoes hurt. And she's like, okay, we'll take them back.
Right.
So when she brought them back, we look like this. Instead of her just taking it on the chin, she's trying to fight with me so she won't look stupid in front of her son. But it's just like, come on. People do that day in and day out. I didn't wear them. It's like, just be 100. So you know what? I grabbed them. I want it hurt a little bit. I don't want anything. I just want to buy another pair of shoes. Maybe we can kind of work with you and just damage the pair up, but don't come in playing on our intelligence saying you didn't wear the shoe.
It wouldn't be a normal day in the world if somebody wasn't trying to get over somebody else. That's crazy, though. But then again, I can't talk because I had my aunt do that, and it's worked out plenty of times for me. The Bodega Special Edition Adidas CX Flux Space Odyssey. Those are actually nice. I actually tried to look those up in my size. Couldn't find them. Nike Hyper Dunk 2015 Low Rio. Nike Zoom Fit. They were nice.
No, Hyper Dunks is terrible this year.
They nice. I actually seen them. I was like, you know what? These ain't bad. Like, I wasn't feeling the heel like you either. And then
that heel is thick, bro.
Man, I got past it.
It's like a wedge for dudes.
Nike Hyper Dunk. Oh, I said that. Nike Zoom Vic 2 Retro Falcons. The Air Jordan Retro 1 High GS Wolf Gray Photo Blue. Saucony Shadow 5000 South Beach. Nike Air Force 1 Low University Red. Nike Roshe LD 1000 Varsity Royal. Nike Air Max 95 Ultra Dakar Slate. Concept Special Edition New Balance 575 M80. I think that's a re-release. These probably were my favorites of the weekend. The Nike SB Dunk High Flamingo. You also have the Nike Women's Air Max 95 Ultra Dark Gray Total Orange. The Nike Field General 2 sees the spotlight. The women's Nike Free Flyknit 5.0 TR Multicolor. And last but not least, the Nike SB Stefan Janowski Cork. And the ugliest release of the week is the Masani Special Edition Converse Chuck Taylor Summer 2015 collection. I really didn't want to do it to Converse, but they did it to themselves, so it is what it is.
Hey, can I let everyone know something?
What's that?
They they re-released that Kobe Prelude pack.
Yep.
And I got a million phone calls like, yo, bro, you want to buy these Kobe 1 Preludes, blah, 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 blah. And they lying, like, yeah, I've had them since they released. I just been holding on to them. Like, do you not know that, you know, like, this is what we do? You know what I'm saying? Like,
y'all knew about the re-release.
Yeah, I checked the re-release, so it's like, I know that you didn't have the first ones. You know what I'm saying? Like, right. Come on, man. Like, now all of a sudden you got 16 pairs of Kobe 1 Preludes. Like, no, you haven't had them this whole time. So don't try to whack me over the head as if these were the first drops.
Well, he got the OGs or something.
Yeah, man. Like, miss me with all that, man.
Sheesh. Only worn them once, and they split at the sides.
Was that the lady at the store the other day? Yeah.
Man, so... But yeah, that just kind of had me a little irritated over the weekend.
Yeah, that's crazy. Real quick, let's take this call from Taron from Philly.
Philly. Meek Mill.
Yellow.
Hello.
What's up, man?
Hey, what's going on?
I'm living.
I mean, I can tell from the sound of your voice, you're not really into it. It ain't Monday, it's Tuesday, man.
I know. I said in the beginning of the show, I'm started off kind of off on the wrong foot, so I'm gonna try to get into the swing of things as we go along.
Yeah, everybody had a good weekend this week.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, it was good. All right.
Real quick, I guess before I get into my question, because I went and got the Bordeaux this weekend. Cause I used the Sneaker Villa, the new reservation system that they got. Cause and then I went to Ubique and ended up getting the A6 too. But a lot of people still don't know that Villa is doing reservations, so like it was still pairs available, and people couldn't get until later on in the day because they didn't reserve a pair online. So it was just crazy seeing all that, and it's a big sign, and like all the Villa doors is telling people how to reserve their pairs, and they still ain't do it. So I don't know. I guess it'll catch on at some point.
Right.
But those A6 from Ubique, those are pretty cool too. And I almost didn't get them because like I got a couple pairs like teal shoes. Like I got those Epitome Sacconis that came out maybe like a month or two ago. I got those, but ended up getting them because I'm like, I mean, I might as well. But one thing I've seen this weekend too, just with people with the Bordeaux, like people are, oh, they're not the 2011 pair, but like everybody's saying it. And it's just like, yo, just enjoy the shoes you got now. Like, if they're not the same, then why even buy them? I see people complaining, yet they put a vlog videos on the YouTube channel going to spend $200 on a pair of Bordeaux. Like the views ain't that important to where you want to spend $20 on the shoes you just want to complain about.
Right.
That don't make sense.
I mean, but, weren't they closest to the original than the 2011 pair?
Yeah.
So people that's complaining obviously don't know what the hell they're talking about.
I just find that ridiculous. Like, people are so quick to judge everything, whether it's good or bad, that they don't let things marinate. Like, I know, like, Future album just came out. Within 15 minutes of the album being out, people was calling that thing a classic. It's a good album, but come on now. Like, the album been out for 3 days, and you calling it a classic. All of a sudden, the Bordeaux, you got them in hand for 5 minutes, and they trash. Like,
well, hype and cynicism seem to go hand in hand, and the thing, like, I'm cynical myself, and so when everybody's cynical, it kind of like doesn't allow me to stand out like I normally would. So, you know, I would like for people to calm down with the cynicism. As far as the hype, that just goes with anything. Like, everything is the hottest. Everything is the greatest thing right now. Everything is the hottest thing right now. Like, as if.
I'm so excited!
There you go. As if, you know, like, right now, they're talking about. Like, somebody actually had the audacity. I think it was. Remember when Brandon Jennings, he should have been traded just for saying this. Said Chris Brown is better than Michael Jackson.
Oh, yeah.
It's like, dude, like, in what world?
Right, like, where?
Like, when? Like, you know, like, now, that's because Mike's dead and he's not. Yeah. Like, that's the only thing, like.
But even still, I was still throwing the Mike Jack record before Chris Brown record.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah. I mean, people have a tendency to look at things now without the context of history. And so,
that's also not being knowledgeable. And that comes along with it, too. When you got so many people getting in the game because it's a fad. And, like, sometimes I wake up and I'm like, man, do I really want to do this sneaker stuff sometimes? Because it's just like, prime example, this guy, you guys should see my face. He's going to come in the store, right? Older cat, right?
Mm-hmm.
So he's like, oh, man, y'all got the, it was like he picked up the basketball Hirachi, the flight Hirachi from 92 and what the Fab Four was wearing in 94.
Right.
Around that time, 93. So he's going to come up to me saying, oh, yeah, remember, y'all got the Hirachis with the bubble in it? I said, which Hirachis with the bubble? No, back in the day, the U of M, they had the Hirachis with the air bubble through the whole hill. I said, no, sir. Yes, I am. You don't know. How old is you? I'm like, I'm 29. You don't know. You're too young. You don't know what it is. I pulled it up on my phone. He don't know who I am. So, you know, right. So I just played my role. I said, I pulled it up. Like, these are all the Hirachis that came out, sir, basketball-wise. Yeah. No, they had the air bubble, man. You don't know what I'm talking about. You don't know what I'm talking about. And it's just like, you got the kids who don't know it. They just in it because of the hype and it's a fad. Then you got the OGs who don't really remember correctly. And it's just like, and I'm here standing between the Hard Rock and the place, like you ain't going to tell me that these Hirachis had an air bubble.
Man. Remember that dude that said the Ed Jordan 4 is that lambskin?
Yes, man.
Remember that?
I wanted to kill somebody.
Yeah, he was like, they originally came on lambskin. I'm looking like, what?
He was telling me, like, the same thing, guru.
Yeah,
like,
how old are you?
No, how old are you? I've been doing, like, what, bro? Like,
yeah.
Okay.
Like, duh, like, so you're an old idiot.
I ain't even want to tell him.
And it's my fault because I was supposed to teach this nigga class a long time ago, and I'm getting lesson plans together.
So had you taught that class, he'd have been well informed.
Yes, yeah, so that's partly my fault.
You'd have knew his Hirachis. Shame on you, guru.
Yeah, I know.
So I do got a question for my man in Philly since I was talking about Meek Mill. Like,
oh god,
how is Meek Mill received in Philly? Like, is it the same like on the record?
I would say before he cut his hair and all that, when he was dropping Flamers mixtape,
yeah,
it was a lot more received well because it was like our best kept secret. And it was like, why don't people know about Meek Mill? Like, now you hear dudes, like, you still got people who love Meek Mill, but you always got people say, well, he's not as good as he used to be. Like, I remember Flamers, and I remember when he was down here and South Philly somewhere, and he rhymed with his bike, but now he Hollywood. Like, they don't want to see certain people shine because he's not here. Like, he's still cool with me. Like, I still listen to his music, but, like, some people, like, it's like 50-50 in the city. Like,
Okay.
It's extremely iffy. It's like saying like Geno's a pet. Yeah. Like some people don't want either. Like
right.
I think it's also with our culture too, and it's like you have to be happy for someone. Like the objective is to get out to hood, right? You know what I'm saying? And then you go back from time to time to do in the hood, but you can't go and stay in the hood because like Biggie said, like on even on the record, like you have envy and jealousy can take over somebody at any moment, and for them, they'll make a name off of themselves by getting you out of here. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So, yes, you worked your whole life and endured those conditions and went in and out of jail to better yourself and to get out of the hood. You know what I'm saying? No one's in the hood by choice. No one said, you know, I'm going to be born in this project and this apartment building on the corner. No, you know what I'm saying? You work your way to get out of there. Right. And I'm happy for anybody who makes it out and then gets their family out. You know what I'm saying? Because nowadays, people, if you can go back and still get love and people not be jealous or you got to be fearful for your life, then yeah. But with nowadays, with people, especially these young kids nowadays, you have to get out. And that's one thing I hate when they say you go Hollywood. No, if you go Hollywood and you don't put on for your people, then that's going Hollywood. You know what I'm saying? Like, right. Tiger Woods to me is going Hollywood. You never embraced your black side. You never did anything for black people or did a camp or reach out to black golf people who was trying to do golf. That's going Hollywood. When he goes and still shoots videos and gives back and does Christmas things for his city but live elsewhere, you can't be mad at that because he also has a family he has to take care of. So.
Right.
Nah, like, I appreciate him, because without him, we would have never got that House of Hoops with that Puma lad. Like, I don't wear Pumas, but I'm finally glad we got a House of Hoops that I could actually go to, because, man, that was tough.
Right. Well, I feel you.
That's dope, man.
But thanks for calling in, man.
Dang, appreciate it.
Hey, y'all have a good one.
Hey, real quick, though, like, I see that Shaq Fu on there, but, like, they got, okay, so Shaq's drink, but he looks like Glenn Rice.
Let me see.
It looks like Shaq a little bit, though.
It's the Glenn Rice. You like Omar Epps and Glenn Rice.
No, you talking about the little chin strap beard thing.
That's
Glenn Rice, but like, for the most part, it looks like
cut it out. All right, let's get into this news.
All right, man. So, first of all.
Yep. Go ahead.
I feel like the city owe me a little bit, man. I ain't going to lie, man. I don't care what people might want to say that they already thought about it and it was already in play. Like, Sneaker Bar and Nojo really made an official push for SneakerCon to come to the D. And regardless of how you want to look at it, Sneaker Bar and Nojo are huge parts of the sneaker culture here in Detroit. So it's like, why wouldn't the biggest sneaker convention, you know, want to come here, you know? So with that being said, you know, SneakerCon is coming to Detroit August 29th from noon to 7 p.m.
There you go.
Mm-hmm. You can purchase your tickets now.
I really like the fact that we started recording in front of a live studio audience. That's crazy.
yeah. Shout out to the audience.
Yeah, that's good.
Tickets are only $25 and only online. But and it's at Kobo, man, just where it should have been. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Where
else was it going to be at? Right. Comerica? That'd be the day it rained.
If they would have put it at Ford Field, though,
that'd have been dope, epic. That'd have been dope, too.
But
Ford Field.
I'm not mad at Kobo, you know, especially with something like SneakerCon. They'll get Kobo to, like, open up, you know,
I want
to
see the changes. Homes. I haven't been in there since they...
It's nice, man. It's
added
nice.
That. You seen that new wing?
Mm-hmm. All
right.
Yeah, I went through there. Check it out. Yeah, it's super nice. But that's big, man. Nojo will be in the building, for sure.
For shizzle.
So we talked about that new Nike sneaker that helps the people with disabilities.
That's why it is.
So I guess what the story is, this kid named Matthew wrote a letter to Nike, you know what I'm saying? Basically asking them to make a shoe that you know, suited, you know, people with disabilities, and they did just that. So we got the, what was the shoe called? The Flyies.
Yeah, LeBron Soldier 9 Flyies.
Yeah. And please don't try to let me not see a pair of these on like Flight Club, because I'm not going to sell them.
Well, you know, that's the thing that kind of got me, because as I was reading it, they said they sold them in limited quantities. Yeah, and I'm kind of like, why would you limit a shoe that's like, supposed to be for a dude? Like, no, like, so you might have to make the height. Because I can see it. Don't let me see a well-abled person, man, wearing this shoe. Like, this is not for you, man.
Yeah, like, I'm not even going to, like, don't call me asking me how much I'm going to buy them for. Yeah. Because I'm not. Give them to me, and I'll just give them to somebody who deserves it. Leave it
to Nike to try to create hype around a shoe for disabilities.
They monsters.
They are horrible people.
I've been hearing about this, man, but I think the world will end if it happens. The Air Jordan Retro 11 Red is a potential holiday 2015 release, and that's the all red joint, you know, that Mellow PE. Bro. It'd be too heavy if that shoe dropped, man. Like, too heavy.
People, I'm saying right now, if you got that and the 72 and 10s coming up, oh my goodness, it's going to be a lot of utility bills not getting paid that month.
Yeah, man.
A lot of payment plans going to be set up.
That's insane, man. Brace yourselves if that happens. Then
hope it do. I want a pair.
Yeah, oh yeah.
I want a pair. I just wanted to deal with getting a pair.
I will have a pair. Believe
me. Oh, I know you will. I'm just saying. I don't feel like going through the hassle.
I called this too, man, because it was like, what else was left? But this year, the Dornbrecher will be the Air Jordan Retro 13. I think it's going to be sick.
They didn't do Dornbrecher 7s, did they?
Nope. They haven't done 7s.
They did everything else.
They three. No, they did 3s.
11s.
11s.
11s. 7-11s, 14s, 15s, 16s.
12.
Man, when you think about it, they did do a lot of them.
Yeah.
14.
I wonder, like, how high are they gonna go? You know what I'm saying? Like, will they ever do a 17? You know what I'm saying?
That would be hard, though. Like, honestly, I
16 too.
Yeah,
I'll take a 16.
Yeah, 16.
I wouldn't take a 15, though. Skip that. Skip that number.
I would do a 14, though.
Yeah, I'll do a 14. But you know, like, the Dornbrecher makeup is, like, just about, not always the same, but it got the same elements normally. It's like they throw a clear bottom on a shoe that ain't never had a clear bottom.
Yeah.
And then they put, like, some type of iridescent material somewhere on the shoe, you know, that you never would have thought. I'm not mad at it, because I mean, it's kids, so they want the flashy, you know, so stuff like that.
That's why I try not to say nothing about them.
But you know, you come to, it's like, that's what gets you excited, because you're like, yo, what would a Retro 13 look like with a clear bottom? You know,
I think in the case of the Dornbrechers, I think they can go as high as they want to, because the designs on them are so out there,
yeah,
that sells. It's almost like a what the version of their Jordan,
right?
And so I think that, you know, it kind of like the 23, like the, or what they even call the 23s, or they like the 2009s or something,
yeah, 2009. Anyway,
yeah, so anyway, like, you know, even they can come up with that stupid looking shoe, and you know, I think it'll sell, because,
or how about you just hire these kids since they make better colorways than adults? Right,
knowing Nike, they probably already got them making the shoe. Oh, my bad. That's not here. That's over in other countries.
Speaking of that, man, you know, Adidas is bringing manufacturing to the D, man.
I heard. That'd be what's up.
Yeah. Jordan Brand, man, is releasing another colorway of that Just Don 2. It's going to be, like, gray, I believe.
I thought it was black.
Yeah, I thought it was black, but I'm going to
I've been hearing.
I'm going to save my comments.
Why?
Because I wasn't that impressed with the first one. Like,
the first
one
was hot.
How?
Those were hot, man.
And how?
They were pony hot.
No, they were not.
Bro, you can't sit up here and tell me the Bordeaux's were okay, that the Don scenes aren't that hype, and you were excited for the KD7.
First of all, I didn't say I was excited. I said I bought them. That's not exciting.
So if you could get a pair of Just Don 2s for retail, you wouldn't buy?
No.
You are crazy. No.
You know why? You know why? Because every look.
How much are they? What are they?
They were 250.
All things are not created equal.
The parties were 200, though.
I didn't pay that much. But I will say this. All things are not created equal. That quoted looking pattern, like, was like, okay, like, what the fuck is this? And then on top of that, like, an all blue shirt. Like, I was just like, man, I wasn't feeling it. Wow. All black, it looks better, but it still is like, I don't understand the hype over it.
Here's the thing. When did ponies ever have cheetah print on them?
I don't know.
You don't even bro, pony. You
I don't know. But, like, I mean, if that's the... Okay, well,
you were the KD7 hyenas. If that's the
litmus test, I mean, you really setting the low bar anyway. So, I mean, I'm just saying, like... Man. And I didn't buy the shoe. Honestly, I didn't buy the shoe because I thought it was, like, the greatest shoe ever made. I thought it was like, you know what? This is strange. This is crazy. Might as well have something like that in my collection. But so, bro. I was like, fuck it. But them John, like, I'm just saying, though, but it wasn't a lot of... Here's the problem with that comparison, though. Like, it was no hype for those. Like, wasn't nobody like, oh, these are the greatest shoes ever. Everybody universally...
We're not talking about hype. We just talking about shoe versus shoe.
My point is, though, that shoe was universally looked at as, like, okay, a piece of shit. As opposed to this John C's, it's like, for some reason, everybody's like, this is the greatest shoe ever made. It's like, why?
The quality of it was dope.
The quality was amazing. Well, the box was dope. I mean...
Oh, the box was dope.
I mean, it's all about presentation. You know what I'm saying?
Fuck the box. I mean, I'm just saying, like, the shoe.
That my
that's like my third fuck for the show. Fourth.
My example that I give is, like, how disappointed were people when they dropped the Bread 11s in a regular Jordan box? Like, why did they do that?
That was retarded.
That's how you feel, right? So why would you put such a beautiful shoe in a regular Jordan box? It would just ruin the presentation.
Well, at the time, though, like, as I thought that, I remembered I was at Eastland. I was like, let me get to my car and go home. I don't have a box or shoe at all.
Right.
And they just won the receivership, so we'll see what happens. Maybe they get the Northland treatment.
Oh, yeah, probably. So Supreme and Jordan are collabing for that camo retro 5.
Another shoe I'm not excited about.
I ain't gonna lie, I am disappointed in that, man.
I was like, man, like, Supreme's starting to, I don't know if it just feel like, okay, we can just throw our name on something and it'll be hot. And I'm
but they
starting
can. To get that vibe. But they though. Can, though.
I mean, I know, but, like, yeah. I never bought into that. But I know, I mean, that's what hypebeasts do, buy into that.
This shoe is going to be, like, a $700 shoe. Easy.
It's not.
Watch.
It is.
I know it
Supreme
is.
Supreme means overcharge to people.
I know. Right. I know. I mean, I'm just saying that doesn't mean that it's right, though. Like, that camo, first of all, like, I'm so over camo. Like, camo needs to go away, along with the word hater. Those two things can get in the car, drive up a clip,
and the word from again. And the word hater.
I hate hater because people misuse it and they overuse it. Like,
true.
Hater implies I'm jealous.
Yeah,
right.
Right.
So if I say, hey, like, okay, for example, without saying no names, this one chick, you know, what I'm saying, like, she's so quick to try to, like, bug me. Like, go to church.
Yeah,
right. You need Jesus. Okay, but mm-hmm. then you end up pregnant out of wedlock. Like, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, okay, like, just be quiet for, like, 2 weeks. Don't talk to me. You know what I'm saying? Like, she's in the hospital still trying to give me the code. Like, look. You know what I'm saying? It's just, and then when I said something back to her, it was like, you a hater. I'm like, okay, like, once again, like, why am I jealous of her? Like, hater implies that she's doing something that I wish I could.
Yeah.
And it's like, and that's what I mean by it. It's like, if you have an opinion about something, you a hater. Like, it's just the most ridiculous.
It's a thin line. Like, if your criticism doesn't have any weight or rational to it, then yes, you're a hater. You can be considered a hater. Sometimes the word is used too loosely, but that's kind of different between a hater and having, like, constructive criticism.
But that's what I'm saying. But people don't use it right. And it's just like, okay, you know what? Since y'all don't know how to be responsible with that word,
to the church thing, though, even that you're not perfect, someone's trying to get you on a bright path. That's just like, you don't have all the sneakers in the world. You don't collect all the Jordans, but you still encourage other people to buy shoes, right?
Yeah.
Exactly.
But but it's the difference between not me saying, like, okay, like, buy shoes, because I'm not holding myself to some type of standard and then... doing something.
Your standard is being above hype beasts, right? Your standard is anything above being a hype.
No, my standard is buying shoes I like. I can give a damn what everybody else thinks.
About you, as long as you're not categorized as being a hype beast, right?
I don't think about it.
He did when the MJ brought it up. You thought about it all night.
No, because
that was the standard that you don't want to be, right?
MJ, I'm like, yo,
calling him a hype beast.
Yes, yeah, right. I'm like, dog, yeah, you missed that show. Like, how you calling me? Like, in what way?
Know. In what context?
That's what I'm saying.
How did it happen?
Because he made a joke about I should buy the 1.5s because I can't get to Chicago, you know, because the whole Chicago thing.
Yeah. I thought it was the Golden State thing because he never picks a team, bro. He ever picks whatever team. So she brought it up like he.
As long as you've known me, have I rooted for anybody?
Bro, he wanted LeBron's with the Golden State jersey or something like that, bro. And then she was like, you know, you don't got nobody. You was a hype piece. You should have seen his face, bro.
Only team I root for, because that's what I'm saying. Like, only team I root for is U of M. Like, these dudes think I'm supposed to just roll with one team. I don't care. Like, I got one team.
You can't bash and bash if you don't have somebody you riding for. It's easy for somebody not to have a team.
You can't bash and bash. That's the whole point of this show. And it's like, it's called being objective.
So I got to have a team
to say something about another team.
No. You do that so you can't get bashed, right? So you know I'm my favorite player, LeBron. So anytime LeBron do something wrong, you got a reason
to bash. If you want to bash U of M football, go ahead and bash it. Like,
we talk about doing the NBA football. That's not going on. We're talking about basketball.
NBA, first of all, the players change teams like they change clothes. So it's like, good luck trying to stick with the one team for a number of years. On top of that.
But players have more, NBA players have more impact on a team than opposed to other
teams. I mean, not to mention, I don't really like watching more. I like football more than, I agree with you. But my point is, like, I don't really watch basketball. I don't enjoy watching it outside of the playoffs as much as I used to. I'm more into football.
You sounded like Dirty Harry just then.
Yeah.
I'm partial to it. I'm the other way. Like, I watch playoff football and then all of basketball. You know what I'm saying?
See, I can't do it. Yeah. Okay, like basketball, I don't know. It just,
I mean, I watch Lions.
It's becoming more WWF to me. And so, like, football, like, I mean, I roll with the Lions even though they break my heart every year.
Me too.
But you know what I'm saying? That's why with basketball, it's like, I ain't rolling with nobody. First of all, I don't even like y'all like that. Like, I'm starting to fall out of love. You know what I'm saying? I feel like Common did when, you know, with the West Coast back in the day. So that's why I was like, fuck it. Like, I'm just going, like, I got a million jerseys for, like, a million different teams. It's like, whatever. That jersey look hot. Okay, I'm wearing that today. So that's the point of basketball. But football, when it comes to U of M football, you can't tell me about no other team. I don't want to hear it. Yeah, Ohio State won last year. They ain't going to do nothing this year. I'm going to still talk stuff as if we did something.
See, I'm not a college football guy.
You look at me all you want to.
Because you are here. You slammed David Black like Rich Rodriguez did anything good at University of Michigan.
Who?
You slammed David Black, but you act like Rich.
Rich Rod got slammed, too. I never liked Rich Rod. From the day they hired him to the day he left. Matter of fact, I still got nothing good to say about Rich Rod.
How you think they going to do now?
A Harbaugh? Harbaugh.
I know already. Of course, we know what he's bringing to the table. Yeah, how do you think the team is going to do?
I think they're going
to
do good.
Shout out to my man, Chris Singletary, too. He's a good friend of mine.
I mean, I like what they've been doing so far in the offseason. I like the pickups they got. So, yeah. I mean, it helps
recruiting. And then also, you're going to play for a football coach who did well in the NFL. You know what I'm saying? So, it's a different respect when what's my man's name? First pick, Jameis Winston, went to him for, like, pre-NFL combine workouts. You know what I'm saying?
He got that respect. You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, I think he's definitely going to do some changes. I don't expect us to beat Ohio State. Like, realistically, I don't expect us to beat them. As long as we beat MSU this year, I consider that a step in the right direction. Man. Beat MSU, because I'm tired of hearing their mouth.
Man.
Like, y'all are little brothers. Like, okay, that's like Royce, like, you know what I'm saying, beating you in a couple games of 21 and want to talk stuff. After you done beat him 50 times.
Right, 50 times.
He win 3 games in a row and want to talk trash. It's like, all right, look, you know what? You hot right now. Right. We been hot, you know? So, like, hey, Nike ain't signed that contract with MSU, did they?
No, they didn't. And MSU is not on NBA 2K16, but Michigan is.
Hey, there you go.
But anyway.
Ain't got the greatest fight song ever.
There will be a Foamposite Mirror Part 2 releasing this year. I don't know what that's going to consist of.
It looked like it has like it starts off blue and then it like goes back to silver. Like it's like this.
Oh god!
You gotta see it.
He gonna drool over it.
They should have did like a black chrome one, man. That would have been hot.
That emerald one's still coming out. They got that like mirror look to
for
it.
You know the one emerald I'm looking forward to, the Carolina Foamposite one with the black eye states and tongue with the Carolina blue foam with the clear sole. Those are dropping in 2016.
You're talking about the Carolina ones. They're coming out with the Dr.
No, Jones. not the white ones. They're gonna have a black tongue with the black eye states where you put your laces through.
Right.
And then the foam posit is gonna be Carolina blue and the sole's gonna be
What about the leather? That little leather strip that goes down, like, you know, the top of the shoe. You know,
oh, oh yeah, it's all black. All this all part black. Right here is
gonna be, oh, so it's going to be black and powder blue.
Yeah.
I got to see clear, that.
So. Yeah, I had to see it.
I got to see that. I mean, I love phones. I mean, for me, like, you got to really work hard to make them horrible. Like those elephant print pink ones.
Oh, my God. That was a disaster. Oh, and lastly in news, man, my ex just signed a 3-year deal to Stance. And
Caitlyn Jenner,
and she—that was good. And she's only dropping 1,500 pair.
Oh man, that's crazy! You know, them nice. And those are really coming out.
Right here. That picture just confirmed. It was on nice kicks too.
Cause that, look at that shank plate. Look at the carbon fiber.
It look like Royals almost.
Yeah, it's coming out. It's on nice kicks. Go back.
Wait a minute. Don't mention other shows.
Hey, you asked for the source, bro. You asked for a source.
You write it down.
They got to bleep that out.
Yeah, we got to edit this show.
And for the record,
mentioned old boy. When they had interviews, he made reference to them, bro. Who? But anyway, everybody know what this thing brought a trip all day. Yes, he did.
Okay, yeah, we got.
Remember, because he does the sneaker. Old dude over there do the sneaker interviews where he goes in the closets of people and stuff like that. You mentioned that before.
Okay.
And for the record, man, my ex is Rihanna. I'm not giving credit to any of them.
Well, there's a reason why she's your ass, because she's my main squeeze.
Any
right
of those
now.
Bad.
No coincidence. I read that Jay-Z on Roc Nation, he owns a part of Stan stock. So.
He does, for sure.
Well, there you go. Who would have thought socks would have been so big? Sneakers. Like, really?
And blew up the dad thing.
No, that's what I'm saying. Like, I mean, go back 5-10 years ago. Well, nobody really talking about socks.
You're
like
right.
That.
You're right.
But that's a credit to the younger people in generation.
Yeah. No, I mean,
it's the sneaker game, bro. I swear. All these sock companies owe it to the sneaker game. Yeah. Hands down.
But
and joggers.
And any
jogger companies owe the sneaker game too.
Oh man. You know what? Some people belong in joggers, some people don't. That's why you don't see me in them.
You look silly.
Yeah, I know. No, it ain't a good look, man. Sorry. this week is stupid. It got this store. Well, this isn't really stupid, it's actually pretty smart. The store is letting people win Yeezy Boost 350s with the vending machine. Urban Necessities, a buy and sell sneaker store in Las Vegas, has a claw machine stocked with sneakers like the Adidas Yeezy Boost 350s, the shattered backboard Air Jordan 1s, and even older shoes like the Grinch Nike Zoom Kobe 6s. The store says sneakerheads from around the country have come to the store to win a pair of shoes. Why? It only costs $5 to play per game. So if you're really good, you can get you some Yeezy Boost for $5. The Vegas store has managed to keep a steady rotation of sneakers in the machine. As of right now, the entire machine is stocked with Adidas Yeezy Boost 350s. So, as of now, there's going to be like a herd of people. I think it's,
even if you win it, it's probably not even your size. You probably to fit in the vending machine.
You think they're thinking about the size? I guarantee you, most of the people going in there thinking, okay, set up my eBay account now so I can just go ahead and
rush. I would want to win to try to get my size.
You would. I'm talking about most people.
Then why create a platform for people?
Well, the store is just trying to get traffic into the store.
Mm-hmm. That's a
good idea.
No, yeah. I thought it was, I mean, that's what I'm saying. I almost didn't want to put it in This Week in Stupid, but it was pretty good, though.
Yeah.
It's stupid in a good way.
It sound pretty, like, desperate, though. I ain't gonna lie. But it's cool.
You know, I want to answer this one. We got Darius in Youngstown. He just bought the Berdews. People bashing them. Go ahead. What's up, Darius?
Yo. Can you hear me?
Yeah, what's up, man?
Not much. I was just wanting to get y'all a question on the Bordeaux. Did any one of y'all pick the 2015 pair up?
Yep, I got them.
Yeah, I did.
Like, what's your opinion? What you think between, like, the 2011 pair and the 2015 pair, because I picked Browns up for our local villa up here, and it was just like the biggest arguments of, well, the 2011 is better than these, and then some people that couldn't get the shoe, that they was mad, so they were trying to bash, like, people who was picking up the shoes that didn't get an opportunity to pick them up, and it was just chaos this past Saturday where I'm at.
Well, once again, I'll fix my mic. Well, people don't know. You got to do your sneaker history. Like, that's to let you know how young the sneaker culture is for the majority of people that's partaking in it. Because anytime they drop a remaster and they give you the exact same model Jordan or close to it, colorway wise, as he wore 92, and you seeing not the 2011 pair is better than this, and it has the Nike inserted and everything. It just lets you know that the sneaker culture is almost about to come to a civil war versus the veteran people who know what they're talking about and the new people who come in the game and try to be a part of it. So, I mean,
side gets the Confederate flag?
The young people.
Like, I'm not even taking no parts right now, but it's just, at the same time, man, that's what I think it is. It's just unnecessary. It's like, do your homework, bro. Like, guys, oh, this soul's dark on here. It's not. It's like, yo, he wore that. You know what I'm saying? I had to show people who come in my store because I work at.
Man, it still comes down to personal preference, though. I mean,
yeah, but like don't the bash the colorway because you think you say, you know what? I prefer the lighter soul versus the darker. That's right. How you go about it. Don't say, oh, this trash. It's like, bro.
So it's about the etiquette.
Yes, of course, about etiquette. You know what I'm saying? Like, yo, I just prefer.
No, I just get clearing it up.
The darker soul, but like, yo, if you would know anything about the sneaker culture, this is how you wore it in '92. You're so young. You thought when it came out in 2011, this is how it is, and then Jordan flipped it and made it darker and pissed you off. No, it's not. But
right,
it is what it is.
And it was just like the fact that they was bashing people though too. Like, if you didn't, the people who had the opportunity to get the shoe, and it's their first time getting it, you know what I'm saying? Let people, you know what I mean, enjoy that shoe. Because for me, I didn't have that shoe. It was like since I was a kid, so I didn't get a chance to get the 2011 pair. So I ain't had a shoe since I want to say since I was like what, in the sixth grade maybe, right? Like back in 2000 or 99. So, you know, I was excited to get the shoe, you know, and especially with the Nike Air, that made it even more, you know what I'm saying, significant for me to get it, though, and just to have it in my collection. But I just be feeling bad for, like, the people who just started to getting in the shoes, whether they kind of know the history or not, because, like I was telling this one guy, like, you can't bash somebody for just somebody who just started. That means they just started learning, you know what I mean? So you can't expect somebody to know something if they just started learning the material,
and
you know what I mean?
And then that's where, if you're a true fan of sneaker culture, that's where you kind of inform them or show some type of guidance. Like, yo, bro, you know what I'm saying? Cool, it's your first pair. No, this is how I look. Well, that's my kind of intake in it. That's how I figure. Like, when people try to come in and say, yo, this is how it originally came. This is how it came about. This is where it is now. You know what I'm saying? And this kind of was pushing me. You know, I found a room over here in downtown Detroit and getting my lesson plans and things together. I actually teach a sneaker class, you know what I'm saying, since I help Villas with theirs.
Okay.
It's the sneakerology class. So mine's going to be called, kicking knowledge. You know what I'm saying? And it kind of, it's the reaffirm from the people who've been in it. Sometimes you got people who fell out of love, now they're back in it. You know, girls who want to participate in it now. And then for the newer guys, it's just to bring it everything together. So you know why this LeBron looks like this. It's not for style reasons, for performing reasons. You know what I'm saying? Like, concept cars aren't the cleanest, dopest cars, but you like them because of what the ability of they have to do. You know what I'm saying? So the same thing, like, you shot for a car for a specific person. You also do.
Sign it up.
But you also do the same thing.
Clap with the syllables. Right. Like,
well, you do the same thing as far as with the shoes. But, sorry, I tripped over a pony saying that. I tripped over a pony, you know what I'm saying?
I bought one horrible shoe. One out of like hundreds.
No, you bought one horrible shoe and bashed great shoes. That's the
man,
issue.
That shoe was not great, man.
Right, we got a question, Darius, bro. Would you buy the Don C. Jordan 2 or the KD7 pony?
That's a horrible comparison.
No, No.
That's a horrible.
I'm buying the Don C.
Okay, but Caesar
said. That's a horrible. Because I'll be the first to admit the shoe is not that attractive. I tell you, it's ugly. I personally bought it for myself. But at the same time, too, that doesn't.
Right.
Look, just because this is ugly doesn't mean that's cute. You know what I'm saying? No. Like, dog, like.
But you said that Don C. Jordan was not a good shoe.
I said it wasn't.
So how can you buy a trash shoe and then say a shoe that has quality materials is not good?
Quality materials and looking good is two different things. Like, ugly people dress nice.
Bro, a quilted leather versus a pony that had cheetah prints. Like, ponies don't even have cheetah prints,
dude,
bro.
Once again, ugly people dress nice. Having good materials doesn't mean it was good looking.
Bro, the shoe isn't good looking.
Well, nice. Can I give you a shoe?
What's that?
Oh, my fault. Well, this Saturday that's coming out, these 1.5s.
Trash.
Like, again, me personally, like, I kind of like them a little bit, you know what I'm saying? But that's like an offshoot, too. You know, a lot of people, like, for instance, didn't get the Chicago ones, you know what I'm
saying?
Or have the twos.
Right there.
You know what I'm saying? Because thanks for coming. I know how mad you was, Caesar, because I was the same way. You know what I'm saying?
I'm not getting no, no, man, because that's like a slap in the face. It's almost like, okay, like, so I'm going to get these, like, hybrids because I couldn't get the real shoe. Like, every time I look at them, you know what it's like? It's like not being able to have a kid, but then you got to adopt. Like, yeah, okay, you got the kid, but it's like, you know, bro, it's not mine. I'm
saying, like, if he never wore them, that would have been one thing, bro. Then I'd be like, you just trying to hit us with a Jordan 1 Son of Mars. You know what I'm saying?
But he wore them. Right. I mean, I get he wore them, but it was like, I mean, still, it's like, it's not that.
You feeling that way going. Because the Chicago ones already dropped and you didn't get them. So now they come up with the 1.5. You feel like
even if I had the Chicago ones, I wouldn't want them. I'm like, why?
Because,
like,
I just said, because they came out first, bro. If these would have came out first.
No, I still wouldn't want them.
You still wouldn't want them, but other people would have.
Well, that's all I could do is speak for myself.
Congratulations. Has any of y'all seen them in person yet?
Yeah, they're at my store, man. I work at the Villa. They're there. And, that came in.
Well, how's the material? The quality?
I don't like hybrids anyway.
They're cool. I mean, the material's on the cool. The leather's pretty dope. It's not as soft as the shattered backboards, but it's, you know, it's a little bit better than the normal retro one.
Ain't about those fusions. So ain't about no Jordan Sons. It's cool.
It's just the soul.
The backboards got my heart for the year, man. I ain't gonna lie. So far.
You got your heart.
Yeah, so for the most part,
so in between Rihanna and those shoes.
Man, me and Rihanna, man, we through. I done moved on.
Oh, man. She's a big fan of the show, too. She's heartbroken hearing this.
Yeah. She texted me last night. I wasn't tripping, though.
Be crazy.
I let her know I read it, though.
All right, man. Thanks for the call.
Thanks, man. Take care.
All right, y'all take it easy.
We got David in D.C. Favorite
snack. Hey, what's going on, fam?
What's up, man?
You rocking phones right now.
Yep. You got your phones on?
Yep. Nah, not today, man. I rocked it yesterday, though. But I kind of agree with the caller, but then I kind of disagree, too. And here's why. A lot of young people that come into the game now, just because you look up something on a search engine, that don't make you a daggone expert. You know what I mean? Right. And with the 2011 pair of the Bordeaux's, to me, personally, if I had a 2011, I'd have passed on the one that came out on Saturday.
You know what? You feel the same way I did with the Chicago 10s. Because I actually like the 2012 Chicago 10, especially that sock liner. So, like, if I had still had those good, I probably would have passed on these that came out this year.
Yeah, but don't get me wrong. It is a dope shoe, though. Right. The only kind of gripe I have, for the most part, on the toe box, I don't know about that little bump. That seemed kind of weird to me. That little bump that's on the toe box.
You sure it's not just your shoe?
It ain't just my shoe, Jack. Everybody's shoe that I've seen kind of had like a little bump right before the Bordeaux color part.
It might be just the Washington D.C. shipment.
Hey, go ahead, man. I heard you wearing that ponies today too.
Yeah. I got them on in the studio.
They're hyenas. He got them customized with cheetah prints, so they're hyenas.
There you go.
Man. Hey, don't go to no zoo today.
Exactly. I'm not. We right down the street from one.
Hey, he got to be careful because, you know, Peter got a strong presence out here in Royal Oak. They might get you coming out the elevator season.
Hey, they can try. I got something for him.
Man, I would wear some pokey nose before I wear them pony joints, man.
Oh, don't say that.
I don't know about that, man. I was on your side.
Don't say that. Don't joke, you know, it's ridiculous.
Now, David, real quick, though, since this is going to be a debate all day, whether Caesar likes it or not, would you rather buy these Just Don Retro 2s or these pony, whatever?
KD7s.
Yeah.
I'm not a fan of 2s, but I'll rock the Don C's over them KD7s.
Okay. I've been admitting that they're not attractive. I'm not trying to convince. It, bro. Here's the problem. I'm not trying to convince somebody that these shoes are worth buying. I bought them for me, for myself. I'm saying just because the ponies are horrible does not mean the Don C's are nice.
But this is how I'm looking. This is how I'm looking at it, bro. You still, even though you don't like that shoe, like you're a sneaker guy. You know, like some people just hate all 11s, but you got to respect them. You know what I'm saying? You got to respect that they wanted the better shoes. That you
here's
know,
the thing. I'm not even saying no.
But you, okay, don't even got, you don't even got that phone.
Let me rephrase. Let me rephrase you got it. Enough respect let me rephrase for it for ugly KD. Let me rephrase it for you because I feel like I hit a nerve. What I'm gonna say is like this. I don't understand the hype around them. They are not that great. They're not horrible, but they do not deserve the hype that they get. It's ridiculous,
bro.
It's
like, dude. Bro, it's a collaboration shoe. It's gonna have the Don C people and the Jordan people. So that's what creates the demand for it. Like,
you buying it for the name, then that's the problem.
It's not the name.
It's a culture shoe to me. It's big.
You're
man.
Bringing two things together. Fashion and sneakers always went together. So when you got someone from into fashion coming along with sneakers, because how the people who wear Jordan,
I'm
wear
just
Don
saying,
C
like, I mean, I'm just saying, like, ooh, I mean, if you bought them because they said Don C.
You know, that's not the reason why people are buying them, bro.
That's what I'm saying. It's like, I mean, I say some Jordans ugly. Like, I mean, like,
but okay, people not buying them because of the quality in them, bro.
What collab is going to be better, the Supreme or the Don?
Oh, the Supremes are horrible. So I say the Don's better than the Supremes. Because the Supremes are just a slap in the face to me.
That's going
to
be touchy.
Supremes are slapping the face because they just like, man, we're going to do whatever the fuck.
If we were saying Supreme versus the KD, I can understand you being hyped because the Supreme shoes have a lot of hype with them. You know what I'm saying?
I feel like the Don C's was
hyped. What you think, David? Which one going to be a hotter shoe, the Supreme or the Don release?
Ah, damn. That Supreme looked terrible to me, so I had to go with that Don C.
Yeah.
I mean, even I would say Don C against the Supremes because I just feel like the Supremes, like, you could tell if somebody just phones it in. Yeah. I just kind of felt like that was phoned but in. I put some camo print all the day.
But I do feel like Supreme overall has, like, a more hyped up name than Don, you know what I'm saying? But, you know.
What in the world? Ah, Supremes. Okay. I was wondering, like, okay, somebody's drunk over there in the other room.
Yeah.
Yeah, but now quick question for y'all, man. What's y'all all-time favorite sneakers? And what sneaker got y'all into the game?
I can tell you right now, at the top of my head, sneaker that got me into the game was the Air Jordan 12 Black and Red. That was my first sneaker. Actually, I had some Zooms, but that's the first shoe I remember thinking, okay, I want to do this forever. but I would say my favorite sneaker of all time, I got to think about that. Nah, I thought I had it, but then, I don't know, y'all go. I'll have to say the White Seaman Forest.
That's fair.
White Seaman Forest respect might that. Be the greatest seat, to me.
Yeah. Sneaker that got me into the game was the Flint Grade 13s. I was in the third grade when they came out, and I know that it meant a lot to me because I will always remember the outfit. I wore them with like the jeans that you buy from Kmart that had a hole in the knee.
Nice.
A damn Marley Phoenix Suns jersey and Flint Grade 13s. So I wasn't matching at all, but just how I felt in the shoes and how all the kids treated me at school when I walked in with them. And the way that I yelled out Jordan after every shot in the gym, it just made me feel better. So that had to be the shoe that got me started. But then my favorite shoe right now or ever is the Toro 5 or the Raging Bull 5. You know what I'm saying? By far. It kills any shoe to me. What you think, Guru?
First one to say part of the shoe that got me was the Hair 7s. My mom bought it for me. She made me clean them and keep them neat. So I said that Jordan, but like to really get into the sneaker culture and like first my transition from Jordan to non-Jordans was probably the Air Zoom Flight 98, the Gary Paytons. Not the leather gloves, but the ones with the spandex on them, with the monkey paw on them. Those, and the foam posits. Those are probably...
Yeah, they ain't like six shoes.
I know, man.
It's hard. It's hard.
Maybe the top five. He named it seven.
But I'd probably say the Hair 7s was my first Jordan, so probably edging on to that and probably first non-Jordan. Actually, you know what? I'll take that back. I'll say the playoff 12s because I got them. I was 7 years old and I was just keeping them clean. But when I got the playoff 12s, that's when I knew, like, yo, I want to take, you know, be really into sneakers. So I say playoff 12s.
There you go.
Oh, okay. Well, I say for me would be the Penny Ones, Orlando colorway.
That's nice.
Yeah, the white, black, and I mean, and white and blue.
And what I bought, off the strength of my own money, the first Concords, and then my all time favorite sneaker is the Bred 13s, which I still have from high school.
Oh, nice! That's nice. Dope.
What's up?
Got the 3M on his.
And I actually got a story about that too, because my mom's wanted to buy me some Hakeem Olajuwon, the Spalding joints. I was like, I'll go ahead and cut. I'll get me a job. Thank you very much. I don't need them. Them Spalding joints was horrible.
Oh, yeah.
Right.
Absolutely, man. Absolutely.
Yeah. All right, bro. Y'all have a good one, man.
Man, we appreciate you calling in, bro. Thank you.
Your call has ended.
Sorry.
Damn.
Sorry.
Sorry. Yeah. We brought you crazy light. CPR. CPR.
Sorry.
Oh, my God.
Let's get to Rob in New Jersey.
You are terrible,
real quick.
Bro. You are terrible.
Sorry, David. Let's call Rob and call Rob. He's already called us. Rob in New Jersey. Yo.
Good, what's up?
What's up, man?
What's going on?
How y'all doing today?
Living a dream right now.
I bet you are. I have a question, and I've been doing a lot of research, and I know a lot of people probably touched on it a lot, but when it comes to people wearing, like, replica sneakers or whatever, now, do you consider them actually real if they're made out of the same factory that Nike?
Nope.
They're all fake.
Fake. Replicas?
They're all fake.
Fake. It's like, you can make the same comparison. Would you rather have a replica jersey or the authentic on-field jersey? It's the same thing with those shoes, with replicas.
Probably.
So it's the same comparison with replicas.
Where did you even buy replicas at? Like, what flea market is
it? No, they're online, bro. You can get them. They're online.
It's like, bro, one time I saw you can buy like a replica Ferrari. You know what I'm saying? They build it on top of like a.
But it's not a Ferrari. Like, a Toyota, that bothers me because the whole time I know it's not a Ferrari.
Right.
But like, you know what I'm saying?
Like, some people just do it just to say, like, to open their garage and be like, oh, I got a Ferrari. But you don't. You still got a. Whatever car you
build. They're the type
of
people that like walk past a real Ferrari and take a picture with it with the keys out as if it's theirs. Somebody caught them getting into their car. Yeah,
man. But no, bro, I don't support any replicas, any triple A perfect, none of that. No, none of that, man. Straight, if it didn't come from like Foot Locker, East Bay,
or Nike itself. Yeah.
I'm not with it.
I'll take a sample from Nike, but that's as far as I'm gonna go.
Or a PE from a player. Yeah.
Like that, I've seen a lot of people still debate about this because I don't believe they're real. I just want to hear your take on it because it's like it's not if it doesn't come from the actual and it says in like their little how do you call that their little thing that if it doesn't come from them that it's not not real pretty much
mm-hmm.
like their little clause or whatever on their websites and stuff. Especially Nike, I think they have it there. I can't remember where it's at. I mean, people still going on about this. You know what I'm saying?
Here's a good litmus test. When have you ever heard people who bought the shoes from the store argue over whether or not the shoes are fake?
Oh, all the time at my store, bro.
Oh, yeah. I've
never personally heard it, but, I mean.
People that actually bought the shoe from the store.
Yeah. Oh, y'all sell fake. They be in the store. Oh, y'all sell fake shoes. It's like, bro, we have a Nike contract.
Well, my analogy just blew up in my face, but my point was going to be that you don't have to worry about certain, like, if you got to argue about whether or not it's real or fake, then chances are, like, you already know the answer to the question before you even ask it.
Yeah. I think more of anything, it's like, I think where a legit question would be was, like, a lot of sneaker blogs use certain websites, pictures, who get, like, Marquee Soul or Cop Kicks, you know what I'm saying? They use their picture to say, oh, this is the first look at the 72 and 10 or whatever, Sharpie foam, and then they have them available for purchase. It's just like, they get their pairs early, you know what I'm saying?
Marquee Soul was winning for years.
You know what I'm saying? They get their pairs early, so it's like, are you going to say their shoes are fake? Because they didn't come from Nike, but they got them early, and you're using their pictures?
I heard Marquee Soul as well.
See, it's so much of that going around right now. Like, I just play it safe. Like, I go to the store, I got a receipt.
Well, blogs still use the pictures, though. It's like, if you wouldn't buy a pair of shoes from that website, why would you use their pictures?
I can't speak for that. I'm just saying. I'm just saying, for me personally, and plus they don't make them on my size anyway, so I ain't gonna worry about it.
Shout out to the producer Notes right now.
Who?
The producer Notes right now.
Yeah. I know the producer. Shout out to our producer Eric.
Yeah, we can't say it because this is a family show. But yeah, you know.
No, well, I dropped like five F bombs.
The last one. Who cares? Who cares? Yeah. Dude, either way. But yeah, man, for sure. Don't buy any replicas.
Oh, I don't. I just wanted to know because there's other people out here. You know what I'm saying? They'd be like, you know, I got this from so and so and so. This looks like the real thing. I'm like, nah, bro. If it doesn't have Nike or Foot Locker, or you didn't get it, you know, have a authentic receipt or whatever. Then, yeah.
Now,
you know
now I will saying? Say like somebody yeah, like. Yeah. Somebody like myself who, you know, I got a resale shop, you know what I'm saying? So, like, my customers have to, I had to build that trust with my customers to know that I sell, you know, 100% authentic sneakers, you know. But that just comes with, you know, me being knowledgeable of the sneaker game, man. You could walk in my store and not, I mean, and feel confident that you're buying an authentic pair of kicks. I mean, especially for, honestly, my prices, like, why would I... If you see a fake shoe, it's normally like too good to be true. You know what I'm saying? Like right. it's like a Bread 11 for yeah. $150. You know what I'm saying? Like it's not happening. My Bread 11s in my store are almost $600. So it's like, you know. And then
new.
Yeah,
I just saw what he typed.
What?
Oh. The different names. That last one threw me through a ringer.
Oh yeah, Major League Yarbles.
I never heard of that. Some 83-year-old right now. I was like, oh my god, earmuffs. real quick too, like this is gonna be like the biggest inside joke in the show. But the answer to like that third question, if you are in a position where you have to ask that question, your life has went wrong somewhere way before then. Way before then. Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, yeah,
you talking about the first one here?
Yeah, like what's real between the H and the T.
Oh
yeah.
Man,
I just dropped like five F-bombs, and I'm like,
hey, but nowadays, man, you can't tell the difference between what, because they out here with surgery, they out cold with it, man. I don't.
Once again,
I got a rule now. If I don't know you,
I'm happily married. I ain't got to worry.
I'm just saying, if I don't know you before now, I'm not taking no chances. Because out here getting surgeries and everything, and then it just. It's already hard enough to find real people, as far as ethics and morals. Then you got to find a real physical person.
You gonna wake up to Caitlyn Jenner one day.
I'm not waking up to nothing, wow. bro. Your man Paul Pierce was looking down at her too.
I know, yeah, you saw that picture.
Yeah, man, checking
her out.
He did it to her.
No, he was looking at her, bro.
He probably did. I don't
he
know.
He was looking at her when she
he's
was
in LA right
out.
Now.
He was clapping. He was looking down at her booty.
Oh man, geez. He's a clown.
Where did he get stabbed outside of?
Huh?
Remember when he got stabbed in the back in Boston?
Oh yeah.
Outside of what?
I remember when they did the Dave Chappelle skit on it.
Yeah, so I got
serious, dude.
I'm like, man.
Oh man,
this guy
Paul Pierce making it hard for himself.
Fuck
Paul Pierce. No pun intended.
Didn't he get traded?
He left.
No,
he's
on
the Clippers, right?
Yeah,
he signed with the Clippers.
Clippers a winner right now,
and they got Josh Smith.
Ooh, oh man, I don't know. That might be the negative, the one negative in the
offseason. I don't know, man. Nah, Josh Smith is.
He did well last year, and Doc Rivers know how to control people.
We'll see.
They got a squad, low key.
The Wizards make it hard for them to go on stud repeat. I don't think them.
Oh, yeah,
back.
They are.
I don't see them going back. Okay, I'm still healthy.
I can't wait to have this sports talk, man. Like, Spurs. Let's get it, man. Let's go.
All right, let me read this one. Hurry thanks, Rob. Thanks for calling. Real quick, let me get this one last story. Why you should never wear your sneakers in the house.
This is ridiculous.
In an article posted by Yahoo, because I guess Yahoo just ran out of shit to write about.
I thought Yahoo died.
I thought it did, too. And this might be helping them die. Wearing sneakers inside your house can be bad for your health. The bacteria known as C. difficile, or C. diff, and it's good to know because my wife is a nurse and she's all into this. Can cause explosive diarrhea, and is commonly found on the bottom of shoes. Eric is loving this story. The best way to protect yourself from C. diff is to remove your shoes upon entering your home so they contaminate your living area and blow up your toilet.
Well, it makes sense because...
No, it makes a lot of sense.
I mean, you know, I take mine out because you got to think. It's like you walk all around places, bathrooms, and then... Like, if you come in the house and don't take your shoes off and walk in the bathroom and use the bathroom, then when you get out the shower, you step in the same place where your shoes. So it makes sense, but...
You want to get C. diff?
I don't think so.
I wouldn't do it, though. I still take my shoes off.
I mean, I don't just walk around, like, the house in my shoes.
They made it seem like if you can't wear a brand new pair of shoes in the
house. My wife...
I'll walk through the house. Like, if I come home, I'll walk to my room and then take my shoes off. You know what I'm saying? But I'm not about to just hit the door, take my shoes off, and then walk
that front door like it's like the Berlin Wall checkpoint. Like, she is just like, no, like, take them shoes off. Like, okay, so it's like this pile of shoes that's in the, and then like the killer part is like after a while, like, cause I'm so lazy, I don't like put my shoes up. She'll just throw them in my closet. So it's probably nothing but like C. diff at the bottom of my closet.
Oh, my closet got to be horrible. I'll never lay in my closet.
Put a black light in your closet. Sports. MJ's not here, so I'm going to hold down the fort. There we go.
I always wanted to be the star player and come out of the locker room.
There you go. We can do that right now. We got the studio audience that cheer for you.
True.
There you go. True. Just run out. We're going to
have the podcast basketball game 2-on-2.
Let's run it, man. Come downtown.
I don't know which part.
Cadillac Court.
I have a hoop down there a couple times.
Bingo.
Before. Oh, man.
Oh, you scared? Don't get scared now, Caesar.
I want MJ.
No. That's, no.
I call MJ.
You got MJ?
It's going to be 3-on-3 then. You're gonna have, if it's going to be that, it's going to be what? Lewis, Juan, MJ?
I don't want to.
How you just gonna be like, we're not even gonna shoot for this?
You guys
no,
gonna get body.
There is no, outside,
we got Lewis no me. That's gonna, you guys gonna get body. You gonna get no rebound. You gonna slow.
I just
the
don't
game
like the way he just did it. Like, he's like, usually you
actually,
take turns.
Actually, I want Caesar, MJ, and me. And then, yeah, that's what I want. Let's play for $50.
What's but wrong with you?
It's whatever. You let me know. We gotta get Caesar to come down there first.
All right, yep.
I'm gonna just throw it to Caesar.
I can't even tell you the last time I was in the city. That's sad. Well, I work there, so man, there you go, every day. Sports. Michael Jordan to be inducted into the FIBA Hall of Fame.
Jordan.
There you go. No surprise there. I don't think anybody's
going to argue against that. I don't think he's going to show up like it's a VET Awards.
Probably not.
Right.
No, Michael Jordan, he's probably going to be out there golfing somewhere.
He don't care about nothing, bro. He just do what he want.
Nah, yeah. I mean, shit, would you do anything different if he was in?
You could take them big old baggy pants off, man. Right. Like, dog, it's like, you mentioned, like,
he ain't never going
to
get
I can't even get mad for kids wearing wax stuff with Jordans and you wearing these gauchos with your retro 13
piece. The difference is Michael Jordan got enough money to change your mind.
Money doesn't, okay, that's even more reason to get your stuff tailored.
But when you got that much money, you don't care.
No, I got no money, you don't care.
I'm not defending it. I'm just saying, like, you give me $100 million a year, watch how much I care.
But you ain't, are you going to wear them pants?
Exactly. Now that I know it bothers you, I would. I would.
You like that.
I would. Somebody you were wearing. He's having a seizure in the studio.
No, that's you. You was like, I would. Like, no, you couldn't I say would. It fluent. Whatever. You would not.
I would. Now that I know it bothers you, if somebody gave me $100 million, first thing I'm going to do.
You going to give me ammunition.
I would do every podcast in those pants.
Hey, do it. We're going to have you jump off the roof. You're going to look like Pootie Tang or Go-Go Gadget.
Hey, Pootie Tang is a good movie. Brett Favre was inducted into the Green Bay Packers Hall of Fame over the weekend. That was cool.
He deserves it.
No argument against that. Mm-hmm. Denver Nuggets guard Ty Lawson is traded to the Houston Rockets in exchange for Kostas, Pablo Prigioni, Joey Dorsey, Nick Johnson, and a protected first-round pick.
Did they use any lube? Jesus Christ.
I think that was a raw deal. Hi-yo.
You got rid of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
How big was this contract?
For Ty Lawson? Didn't he just get a DUI?
I'm the best player in the world.
Yep. We got
his actual audio from Ty Lawson.
His second one.
I guess recently he's been having like a string of problems. I thought he was always a decent.
Is he worth this many players?
I can help it that I'm helping.
Are those players worth it? You ain't never heard them players, so if anything, they got rid of some cap space.
I agree.
Prigioni I've heard of, and Kostas.
But Pablo Prigioni was like the 35-year-old rookie like 4 years ago.
Yeah.
So he's like the 39-year-old veteran. Josh Smith joins the LA Clippers on 1 year veterans minimum deal, so that wasn't bad.
No, it's not bad.
Not bad at all. Dez Bryant, the Dallas Cowboys, agreed a new deal after threatening to miss training camp and possibly some regular season games. Dez Bryant's finally gotten what he wanted, a 5-year deal worth $70 million. It includes $32 million fully guaranteed and a signing bonus of $20 million. The guaranteed money will increase to $45 if he's still on the team on the fifth day of the league year 2016. Okay, one, he will be. Two, this is the type of shit I see in the NFL contracts that just piss me off. Like, just that seems like they just try to screw you. Just the letter, the language in that.
Yeah.
Because, like, the fifth day, like, they'll cut you on the fourth day. Like, wasn't the fifth day. But that will also kick in another guaranteed $13 million in the 2017 season.
Mark Cuban.
Shout out to Roc Nation for getting him that deal, too.
There you go.
What was that, $70 million, too, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah, 70, yeah, for that deal. Yeah,
Mark Cuban wants the NBA to expand the playoffs to 10 teams per conference. Okay, one, logistically, that just wouldn't work.
It wouldn't work.
It wouldn't work. You need even numbers throughout each round. You have 10.
But don't you already got 8?
Yeah, 8. So it's even. 4, 8, 4, 2.
And 10, that even number?
10, and then what happens in the next round? It goes to what? What's half of 10?
5.
Right.
So no.
And what's half of 5?
2.5.
Yeah, there you go.
So, what could be 5-on-3?
Or just take 2 players or 5 players from the team that lost.
I think it should be a wild card in the playoffs, though.
That would be the problem, because now you have to have 2 wild cards, because the first round you'll have how many people?
True.
9. Mm-hmm. What's half of 9?
Do 2 wild cards.
So we're going to do 2 wild cards, man? How about we just keep it as it is?
They talking about having a 4-point line, so shit, we can explore.
Who's talking about having a 4-point line? They do that. I'm done.
Google it. Your boy, Adam Silver.
Man, Adam Silver need to.
They said they talked about it. They haven't really.
Please stop.
Hey, if they considered it, I would.
They talk college football rate players. Oh, yeah, we'll give you a $20,000 scholarship. We make $5 million off your jersey. You can't ever talk about the NBA after what college sports does. Yeah.
They all screw you.
No, it's college.
No, college is worse. I'm just saying they all screw you. Some worse than others. You know what? I want to get this story because I love this story. So I'm watching ESPN yesterday, and I think everybody's seen the video of the guy getting attacked during a live surfing competition. And this is literally the headline they had. Surfer beats off shark live on TV. Now, there's 2 ways you can read that. Now, one, you can read it as an adult and think, okay, well, this guy was attacked by a shark, and he chose to physically defend himself by hitting the shark. Or you can read it like a teenager, as I did, and like, oh, this dude just beat off a shark. So, Australian surfer Mick Fanning, sound like a wrestler, barely escaped a shark attack at the World Surf League J Open. I guess that's the name of the event. J Bay Open in South Africa. I didn't even know they had that type of eventing. Oh, that's in Johannesburg? Oh, okay. During the middle of Sunday's finals against fellow Australian Julian Wilson, the defending champ was attacked by a shark. After getting back to solid ground safely, Mick talked about his encounter. I was just sitting there and I felt something just get stuck in my leg rope. And I was kicking, trying to get it away. I saw fans. I was waiting for the teeth to come at me. I punched it in the back. The competition was eventually suspended for the day. I can't even imagine like the horror that goes to somebody's mind when that happens.
There's another dude that did it on Dateline Special. And this guy is a shark wrestler. So he throws bait on a fishing rod. He wheels it in, and then he wrestles with the shark and injects some GPS in the shark fin, and then lets it go.
Yeah.
My thing is, out of all the occupations in the world, why would you want a shark wrestle?
Okay, well, a number of things. One, I agree with you. Two, it's funny that you mentioned that, because if you watch, I love Shark Week, right? And they do a lot of that, and they have guys getting in the cages and stuff. And you know what I noticed out of all my years watching Shark Week? There are 0 black people, and I'm fine with that. I'm so fine with that. Usually, I'd be offended, like, where are the black people? But it's like, you know, I did see one black person, and he saw this one dude. It was a whale carcass that was just floating in the water, right? And it was like 7 sharks feeding off this one whale carcass. And the guy's on the boat, and he's like, I got to get a closer look. So he goes on to the whale, right? And as he's getting onto the whale, he's telling you how slippery it is, right? Which would be a red flag for most people to not get on at all.
Mm-hmm.
And he had to literally get like a stick to stab it into the whale so he could have some type of leverage to like kind of keep himself balanced. And the one black dude that was on the boat, like the camera guy that stayed on the boat, pans over to like look at the crew. And the one black guy was like, threw his hands up and just walked back into his cabin and go back to sleep. And it was just so funny because I'm like, that's how most, like, I agree with, like, look, it's dangerous enough just surviving Detroit. I'm not going to put myself in harm's way by getting in a cage.
And if something was to happen to you, can you really feel bad for that person?
Well,
you
put yourself I'm just saying, this thing I just refuse to die by. Bow and arrow, shark attack, sword fight. pony. Just, you know, just stupid stuff that you could possibly get killed by. But then also too, reading the article and seeing the headline that a surfer beat off a shark to avoid an attack, it made me think, okay, how many other people are beating off animals to avoid attacks? So like I looked it up. So there's a guy in New Jersey who beat off a bear. It's a chick. I saw the video. You pull up the video. It was a chick in New Zealand that beat off a shark as well. And it just made me think, like, okay, we've been getting like attacks wrong this whole time. Like, you just beat them off and they'll go away. Are you sitting with the TV? So the sharks just want to actually just get beat off. They're not literally looking to bite anybody. Just beat them off. It's crazy. Look at this video, though. Like, it's funny because the guy that's interviewing her obviously is the... He's taking it where I'm taking it.
Hello, today we're pleased to be talking to the girl who beats off sharks.
I pressed something with my foot.
This 14-year-old Kiwi has faced the cameras and admitted she saw a shark near her and she chose to beat it off.
I looked towards my brother's face and he was just shocked.
You're not surprised. The shark was 1.5 meters long, but young Lydia was up to it. So efficient was her beating off, in fact, that the encounter was over in seconds. And over in culturally permissive New Zealand, this flame-haired shark temptress is now a bit of a TV star. If you're wondering, as we hope you are, quite how a 14-year-old knew how to beat off a shark...
I've read, like, articles and things in magazines and a book about it.
They grow up so fast these days. More genius tomorrow.
That's crazy. So, yeah, so this guy, I mean... I guess if you are stuck in a life and death situation where a shark is going to beat you off, I mean, a shark is going to attack you, just beat it off and he'll go away. Actually, do we have live audio for that, for him beating off the shark?
Red Rocket, get out! Carmen, what the hell are you doing? I'm milking the dog, they make dog milk.
Take any subject, Megan, and abuse it.
I will. Here's another thing that kind of got me laughing, though, about sports. Shaq and Scottie Pippen get into this Instagram war over which team between the Lakers and the Chicago Bulls and their greatest five players could beat the other. It's not even a question who will win that. Like, of course the Lakers will win that. They got Magic Johnson, Kobe Bryant, Elgin Baylor, Shaq, and Kareem.
Wait.
Versus... Yeah, Derrick Rose, Michael Jordan, Scottie Pippen. Guess who the last two were?
Wait. The greatest five players from each team, like from each team's history?
Yes.
Oh, my God. Come
on. It's not even a question. I'm like, the Lakers will kill y'all. So Shaq said we would win by 50, which I would agree.
I agree.
Michael might still get his.
We got Shaq, Kareem, Kobe.
Well, the lineup was Magic, Kobe, Elgin Baylor, Shaq, and Kareem.
Oh, my God. Against who?
Listen to this lineup, right? Derrick Rose, Michael Jordan. Scottie Pippen, now you at that, right? Guess who the last two are?
Ooh.
Dennis Rodman and Horace Grant.
No way.
I was like, nah, like
Horace Grant
about to get a beautiful.
No.
Who are you checking?
Dead.
Who are you checking?
Kareem and Dennis Rodman, dead. Who else you got?
But here's the only defense in Pippen's regard. Like, Pippen was beating up on the young Lakers when they were winning before Jordan retired. But also, too, though, yes, Kareem is more athletic, but Rodman knows to get on the skin. He's going to push him. He's going to bother him. You know what I'm saying? Back then, they had fluent defense. It was just put a hand up. You know, back in that day. But Kareem playing against Rodman, he will still do what he do, but Rodman will have to make him work for it.
Shaq and
when has Kareem been
still there?
Yeah, Shaq, because that was the only defender. Yeah.
No.
The defending thing, but.
And even, I mean, Kareem, look, you say what you want to about Kareem. Kareem is, is the reason why he got the most points in history.
Are you talking about?
The most accolades in history.
Magic. And D Rose, first, if the height difference alone, don't get it.
But then again,
and that's if he's healthy.
Man, right? But then again, it's just like they all cancel each other. Because yes, he has a height difference, but Magic can't really score like that. Derrick can blow by Magic Johnson. You know what I'm saying? So
then you still got
if you ask
Kobe,
me right now, who I'd rather
Kobe
have?
Jordan.
Prime Jordan. I mean, Prime Magic.
And you talking about all these players in their prime, right?
Yeah.
So you talking about 81 points a game, Kobe? Right.
Yeah. Magic, like, Derrick Rose,
unstoppable
Magic.
Kobe. Oh.
Come on, man. That's like, nah.
Come on, dude.
Look, man, you want to be one of the greatest players ever. I don't think
Jordan will let him score anyone in that game, bro.
No,
he wouldn't. Of course he wouldn't. But you can't sleep on Kobe, bro. Not that Kobe.
I mean, Michael in his prime, like, I think if this... Mike in his prime, like 96 Mike. If this was the team that they talking about fighting, I think Michael might go back to, like, 88, 87 and just be like, forget my team, I'm about to get mine.
You think so?
Yeah.
I think it'd be 72 and 10, Mike.
Nah.
I think so.
Nah, he knows going in, like, we got Shaq anger. Nah, okay. Just give me the ball.
I would love to see that game, bro. I would pay.
But that perimeter D, the Bulls perimeter defense, you would have to work your way to ball to inside because they're not just gonna let you just dump it inside to the paint though. Well, who's gonna stop it? Game.
Who they have at the three? Who was at the three in both?
Pippen and Elgin Baylor.
Sleep on Elgin Baylor if you want to.
But you can't sleep on Pippen.
I'm not saying I'm sleeping. I'm just saying
that counts each other out to me.
Yeah.
I'm just saying, Elgin was smooth, too. But, I mean, that combination, though.
Yeah. Kareem and Shaq.
There's too many holes in that boat. There's too many holes in that boat to plug.
Yeah.
So, there's not enough defense around. Like, Horace Grant checking somebody, and he getting dealt with. So, like, Magic going to just dump it to whoever Horace Grant is checking. Like, that's...
Kobe Jordan matchup kind of cancels each other out too.
Obviously you get Jordan the edge, but you're right. Like that cancels out. I think Magic gonna have his way with Derrick Rose. To be honest,
Derrick Rose gonna have his way with Magic because Magic defense
depends on which Derrick Rose you getting.
If you getting driving, Derrick Rose, it's not gonna work. You're gonna have to force him to shoot because Derrick Rose not gonna drive up against Kareem and Shaq.
Bro. That's my point. He's not gonna drive, and on top of that, he's not gonna have the ball. Michael Jordan is still there. you gotta have the ball to drive.
Jordan need like a spot up shooter like he had Kerr, like somebody could just post up behind
the dynamics on that team because Magic looking to pass.
Yeah,
but also too, if they play, it depends on if Jordan has the ball and then Magic Johnson got chased. Derrick Rose around the screen.
Oh, yeah. Now, that would be a problem.
You know what I'm saying? So,
that would be a problem.
Or if Derrick Rose did drive and they collapsed, he could dump it to Jordan on the side.
They're probably going to play a team. I mean, Magic ain't chasing nobody.
Why they cast each other.
But they're going to probably play a zone.
No, you can't play no zone.
They can switch. They can probably switch Kobe.
You can't camp out on the 3-point in the paint.
I would switch Kobe off with Magic sometimes on Jordan just because. You know what I'm saying? Like,
no, then Magic gonna get torched by Jordan.
Nah, I ain't gonna get
torched. But that's one player. Like, I mean, look, they got five players on that team that's all Hall of Famers and gonna do their thing. You got Michael Jordan.
Pippen and Rodman Hall of Fame.
Michael Jordan. Then there's Rodman Hall of Fame because of rebounds and Pippen in there for defense.
Yeah. Yeah, Derrick Rose will be there.
Oh, yeah. I don't know if he make it to the Hall of Fame.
He'll be in Hall of Fame.
Think so?
Yeah.
His career. We'll see where it goes from here. But as of right now, I got him out.
In the Hall of Fame, like the people who couldn't, people who made the Hall of Fame. Reggie Miller made the Hall of Fame, but couldn't beat George. You know what I'm saying?
He made the Hall of Fame?
Mm-hmm.
But he has stats and everything else to go with that, though.
Not really.
Yeah.
I'm still waiting for the
Iverson. No rings, though. Right?
Yeah, but there's a lot of players with no rings. I ain't even looking at the rings.
Let Iverson in the Hall of Fame.
I'm not worried about the rings, to me. Like, that's the icing on the cake.
If David Stern was in the league, but I think Adam Silver
if they let him. If they let, like, Tracy McGrady into the Hall of Fame before Ivo, I'm going to have a problem.
Please don't.
Iverson gave work.
Iverson deserves that. I don't know about Tracy.
Iverson gave early Brown work.
Iverson deserves to be there. Yes. Iverson deserves to be there. Tracy.
Trace McGrady was a dope player, but he better not Hall of Fame to me. Ivo,
he's not Hall of Fame to me.
If you think about T-Mac, then you got to put Penny in there. Because Penny was the first T-Mac. What?
Easy. Then you got to put, like, did Grant Hill make it?
No. I think he might have got in for college. Because you can get in for college.
Oh, okay.
Being good and being great, two different things.
For sure.
It had to be over career-wise. No.
That's my point. It can't be hot for a couple years. Steve Francis should be in there then.
even when I went back and looked, Iverson was still, for like 1 or 2 years when he was with Carmelo, they were still dropping 30-some points a game, both of them.
Yeah.
So, Iverson, man, look, he carried
Iverson
Philly.
Iverson deserves to be in the Hall of Fame, period.
Iverson carried Philly. Because
if it wasn't for Shaq, bro, he would have beat the Lakers, bro. Like, Iverson was answering Kobe points, but nobody was answering Shaq points.
I mean, you couldn't at that point. I remember
around the
Matt Geiger can only do so much. Like,
George Lynch.
I remember around that time where Shaq and Ivo was like the leading scorers, bro. That was life. That was life back then,
bro. I seen Shaq dunk on three people, man. Like, that's just... that Chris Dudley dunk will forever go down to me as the funniest dunk
ever. Iverson caught a Tim dunk on Marcus Camby when he was the Raptors, man, bro. Yeah.
Everybody caught Marcus Camby. Who didn't catch Marcus Camby?
Marcus Camby caught Tim Duncan in the final, even though they lost. He caught him, too, but...
That step over Tyronn Lue will forever be, though. AI.
Oh, iconic.
It was like... that represents, like... the black people's mentality, us against the world. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? We had no hope, no help, and he just taking on the leg.
He killed them.
And he then killed Eric.
Iverson, there was no respect right there, man. Because he looked down at him. Like, he looked down at him as he stepped over him. Like, that's
John Stockton getting rocked him. Even with Jordan, for that fearlessness to say, take on Jordan, like, boom, boom. Like, somebody would have rocked him the first time. Like, I got him. I'm just going to get this bucket. Iverson, I'll come here. Come bring that here, boy. And
will say, Michael, it was funny because somebody brought that up.
Michael still won that game with 35. Just that
Iverson he said the very next play. If you go back and watch the very next play, Michael come down and dunk on a center.
Yeah.
Right, so it's just... Michael was like, keep watching the game.
Jordan was ruthless, bro.
Yeah, he was ruthless. Period. But yeah, Iverson got his, though. Yeah, man, that's forever in infamy.
Yeah. But he'll always be one of the greats, man.
But no, I hate Hall of Fame because it's like, in my mind, the way I look at Hall of Fame, I look at who's there, and I'm like, okay, does this person belong in their company?
Right.
And Iverson, I believe he does. Like, Tracy McGrady,
because he played those guys, and he wanted to be. You know what I'm saying? Even going back to college.
Even Vince Carter. I feel like Vince Carter didn't live up to his potential. Like, he could dunk there
before. No, but in New Jersey, he was giving up buckets. Like, the Iverson had a game where, like, him and Iverson were going back and forth. And they both put up, like, 30 games. But
he wasn't consistent in New Jersey.
Yeah, he was. He gave them buckets, bro.
Vince Carter, I would put in the Hall of Fame before I put Tracy McGrady. Easy.
Well, if we're making if we could doing that, yeah.
But not before Iverson, though. No.
I don't think
Tracy Olympics put him in the Hall of Fame.
Jeez, man,
was a savage. I watched the one where when he went behind the back on Jason Williams and then bodied Alonzo Mourning. How you dunk on somebody for two consecutive years, bro? Yeah. It was just he's son.
But I think Reggie deserved to be in there for everything he did. I think he
blew. Did Robert Horry ever make it?
No,
he's not.
Stop it! Don't do it! Don't do it!
No way.
Don't do it.
No.
I guess DJ Benga deserves to be in there too, huh? He got like three wings.
Come on, bro. No, Robert Horry was clutch in a few situations.
Man, look, I mean, you wasn't the reason.
He got them passed. Him and Derek Fisher. He got them passed. That's why I be trying to remind Laker fans, like, bro, it was some times where your role players got you through some series.
I'll give you that.
Derrick Fisher, 0.2 seconds. San Antonio.
But that just happened. That just happened with Golden State. So, I mean, whatever. Because they star player didn't show up. I don't care what nobody
said. Curry, my thing is.
He showed up like games three.
Klay Thompson got locked up.
Well, yeah, Klay Thompson did.
Shamon Shepard locked him up.
Yes, he did. He averaged like, 6 points that series?
Yeah. He locked him up.
I mean, you look at his stats. I mean, dude had like 26, 5 and something. Like,
yeah, it was like he took him like 4 games to get to his Stephen Curry moment. And that was like because Dellavedova was tired. You know
that
would have
never happened to Jordan. Never.
I agree.
Never.
But, I mean, there's a reason why Jordan is Jordan. Nobody else.
It would have happened to Kobe.
Okay.
tell me when Kobe choked.
When Kobe choked?
Yeah, like LeBron did.
He choked. Bro, hold on, let's get this right. You were up 3-1 on the Suns and lost 3 straight, right?
Damn, I knew he was like, I knew he was doing that.
We also talking about Game 7 in L.A. versus Boston. You shot 6 for 22, bro. You shot 25% from the field, bro.
You can go back, you go back 2 years before that when it was up 25 at halftime.
It lost to Boston. In the finals. Come on, bro. Y'all got amnesia over there in Laker Lane. Stop. Take off some of that makeup and those lights.
Your boy choked every chance.
No, he did not choke. He had the one against Dallas. Every other finals he had, he balled out with no help, bro. Come on, man.
Every finals?
What? The Spurs? When he lost, he balled out. Had no team. No, he did not choke when he played the 06 ago.
06?
His third year in the league, bro. He still put up points.
It don't matter.
Here's what I would say. He did choke against Dallas.
But the other finals, he came.
I will
with it,
say
bro.
This:
he showed up with the.
This would annoy me. This would annoy me. The high heel
fake ass. And I'm sorry. Cramps.
Yeah, that was gay. Now here's. Leg I'm sorry, Jay Williams. I'm sorry because I tried to do it. I tried to avoid it. But man, look, if we gonna give somebody credit, they gotta get the blame. Now, if LeBron James won in 06, or was it 07? It was 07.
He's on the Cavs still.
Yeah, it was 07 because Miami won 06.
Third in the league. Yeah.
If he would have won.
That was his fourth, I thought. He came in the league 03, didn't he?
03, 04.
Yeah, so it was his fourth year. Well,
it was like his third
season. Third season. You know, it's like 04, 05 yeah, though. So anyway, if he would have won, he would have got the credit, right?
If oh yeah, LeBron will.
But they lose, it's like oh well.
But because it's still a team effort though. Prime example like this. Fine.
Who else on that team with him? Eric Snow?
Come on, oh, we can bring it down because you lost with better help. That's good. Mm-hmm. Come on now. Well, that's Eric Snow or Kareem or Smush Parker. Which
come
one,
on, bro? I'm
which
one? Eric Snow. Every
you sound
day.
Like a fool, bro. Oh, Smush Parker was though, terrible. On, Smush. Eric Snow was
man.
Eric Snow was better than Smush Parker.
No, he was not. Perimeter, you bro. Beat Eric Snow. That's how y'all got a ring. Clown the good out of here. Right. Cool. Now, who's the two guard? Who's a Kobe?
Smush Parker at right now? Cool. First of all, your name is Smush Parker.
No, Eric Snow.
You losing life.
Eric Snow. You always go.
We had Kwame Brown on our team,
bro. You also had Lamar Odom with a Sixth Man of the Year award. You had Lamar Odom, and you had Bynum, and you had Gasol. I don't want to hear that.
But I mean, in his defense, though, Bynum was a clown.
So Zagauskas wasn't. Drew Gooden wasn't.
Zagauskas produced.
He's solid,
bro. I would take Gasol and Bynum over Drew Gooden and Zagauskas.
Zagauskas produced more than Andrew Bynum did.
Drew Gooden is like Carlos Boozer, little brother. Nah, brother.
Only reason Andrew Bynum is still in the league right now, if he still is, is because he's 7 foot.
Is he still in the league?
Who? I don't even know if he's Zagauskas still in the league right now.
He retired after the first year in Miami.
Who?
Zagauskas.
No, where is Andrew Bynum?
Bynum hurt himself.
They just had like a Zagauskas night like a year ago, didn't they?
2 years.
Right, like, he retired. I'm saying he's right.
But they had a retirement party. Like, he can't be that big of a
because he's the longest Cavaliers player to ever play with the team. That's
and
why.
That means that says a lot, right?
No, it's the Cavaliers. Play. Who did they? Were they a winning organization before Brian came?
I didn't say it was a winning organization. I just said Zagauskas was a good player.
He was more solid than
Bynum.
Yeah.
Bynum gave you like one good year.
Bynum had that one solid
yeah,
year.
Yeah, one good year.
And they traded him.
Yeah, one good year. No.
He played with y'all. He played with y'all for all of y'all finals. He played when they played Boston twice, and when they played
he
Orlando.
Didn't play that Boston series.
He played the Boston.
That's that first one. No, he didn't. Because that was because that's what they was like. Because remember they were saying Kendrick Perkins got hurt. That's when Boston lost, and so Kobe was like, "Well, we didn't have Andrew Bynum the first time we lost to y'all, so like it's even."
I could have sworn he was playing.
No, he didn't play that first series.
Man,
I'm just saying. Like, I mean, Smush Parker though. Like,
come on, Eric Snow, bro. Don't act like I'm not saying trash. That's a cancel out. They both was trash.
I'm saying one is more trash than the other.
Bro, we had Kareem.
Come on, now, like, dog. If you had to pick a team, you mean to tell me you going to take Smush over Eric Snow?
No, you
wouldn't. Yes, I would.
Come on, man.
I would take it not for offense, to give me some height at the garbage. Eric Snow was slow and trash, bro.
And Smush Parker was what?
They was both trash. They both can cancel out. They both was trash.
No, I'm saying they both trash. They both trash.
Where was that at? Where was that at against the Lakers when y'all played? Exactly. This is laughing over there.
I'm saying one is a D and one is a D minus. That's all I'm saying. Like,
they both trash, bro. You
Eric Snow
pass.
Was a D and Smush Parker was a D minus, borderline F.
They still was it cost each other out, bro. It was still terrible, bro. You couldn't sit here and say that he had a better team when he didn't, bro.
I mean, the teams was about Daniel even. If you're talking good. About that team that lost to the Phoenix Suns, that was a pretty trash team.
But my thing is,
you was up 3-1 though.
Exactly. You won three games.
You won three games.
Whatever. We took that one L, but your man, he's a choke artist. Bro,
you know who bailed you out with that game set? Because artist. you shot 25%, bro.
Man, I like to thank the black and white stripe. For bailing your man out.
No, it's not. No, it's not bailing your man's out. It's easy to say that when your crutch scores 38-16.
God,
38-16.
Shout out to the
refs,
man.
That's how many did you make the playoffs when they left?
Sheesh, man.
The Lakers shot 13 free throws in 50 seconds. I don't want to hear nothing. That was blowing out whistle like a U2 Yang release party. I don't want to hear that.
Man, whatever, man.
You guys got bail out. You shot 25% from the field.
They be killing me with LeBron. They be like, LeBron is the first player to score 12
points. That annoys me on a
Wednesday night when the Wolves were
hollering. The arbitrary stat making is ridiculous.
Like, bro.
Come on, man. They don't do that for him?
LeBron's the first player to eat McDonald's and then score a triple-double.
I'm not even talking as far as regards to that, though. I'm just saying, like, don't you want to stick your chest out when you had the best center in the most dominant center in the game. So don't act like you carried that team when Shaq carried that team. As soon as he left, what did you guys do? Nothing. Don't act like you always wanted to be in L.A. when 07 you demanded a trade after signing the $88 million extension there.
But he's still there because they wouldn't trade him.
He didn't switch teams. He ain't had no hours spectacle to leave, on how bro. To go to another team.
Bro, don't act
like But that's, I mean, I will say, that's like saying, like, yeah, let's just, oh,
you can't say you always loyal. You loyal, yeah. Say, no matter what happens, I'm going to ride it all. Kobe never said that.
But I mean, he been there. I will say, that's like saying, well, you and your wife was talking about getting a divorce, but they didn't. You know what I'm saying?
Don't act like, oh, like, we have unbreakable. Nothing has ever broken.
He going to break up. He going to break up, go to another team, win, and then come back. And like, see?
But my thing is, you can say, how many rings you won without Phil Jackson? Exactly. Man. You never made out the first round without a first year coach. Though.
What do that
every
mean?
Every coach, you mean, what does that mean? You couldn't win without a veteran coach. LeBron's taking whack coaches to the finals.
You need a good coach to win anyway.
Thank you. That's my point. LeBron has a good coach.
But I will say this, though. I mean, can I interject?
We had him in years of Rudy Tomjanovich and his terrible.
Who's y'all
I'll take
get?
Him over Paul Silas and Mike Brown.
Paul Silas was a good coach.
We had Mike Brown.
Wait, what did he do in Miami? What did he do in Charlotte?
We had Mike Brown.
First round.
It's Charlotte.
Like, and Rutan Vincent, he did something with Houston.
I mean, but you had Elijah one. Terrible. I mean.
And all those guys want to tell an inquiry. You had Barkley that was like 250, 260. You had the old Akeem Olajuwon.
Barkley didn't
win a championship. You had Pippen from the Bulls, huh? I'm saying they did well as a team. They didn't go far, but they did well as a team.
I thought you were talking about the teams that won the championship.
No, that's the time of age. When he won those guys, when Barkley and Pippen, all those guys left, that's when he left and went to go coach the Lakers. Rockets changed their jersey. They had the blue jerseys. Yeah.
But I don't forget what I was going to say now. I just took it But no, I mean, I give both of y'all saying.
Shout out to Kobe, man. He forever be my favorite player.
I just feel like Kobe's more of a winner, but I would rather play with LeBron because he's not as much of a dick.
I agree. Kobe is a real. Kobe is the last thing that we have that reminds us of the old league, bro. Like,
I'm not gonna say
this
that.
Whole league is soft.
I give him that.
He's the last we have that's left that's really about that real rugged.
I would agree with that.
That shit that we miss, bro.
I reluctantly agree with that.
LeBron can just throw himself on the ground.
Because the league has gotten.
Jesus Christ.
Well, my thing is,
you can't even dunk on nobody for real no more.
You can't look at a player now without getting a foul call. Jesus. Say it's not soft.
Because he played during that thing, but I don't like he's not taking advantage of that. How many times Kobe draw fouls with that pump fake? So don't act like
Reggie Miller did it too.
That was during that time of league, but don't say he's bringing that rugged basketball style back when he takes advantage of these
but
rules.
He the last that we have. You know what I'm saying? Like everybody else done. Conform they play to this new
because that's what they came in the league as. You know what I'm saying? And like you could say that if LeBron and Kobe both came in 96, 97, LeBron's playing like he is and Kobe's playing like he is, then yes. But LeBron couldn't come in the league at that time though. The same thing could be said like this, where Kobe went to all these finals and then was winning finals, but when LeBron came in the league, he only won two.
Yeah,
I mean, he won more when LeBron wasn't in the league. You know what I'm saying? The same thing could be said on the flip side on that.
But it wasn't a LeBron issue, though. I mean,
it's definitely
LeBron
not
ain't
LeBron
stopping. I mean, because he didn't play LeBron in those finals,
especially as interconference. You know what I'm saying?
Got the winning record like that. Yeah, anyway. I mean,
they got to get to the West, which is like the hardest thing to do in the NBA.
And it has been for a long time.
The East is so weak.
Like, but people don't act like the people don't go to the East for the team. They go to the West for the weather, bro. So it's like, or is it our fault that the East Coast got rain, snow, and it's cold? That's why people go to the West. They don't necessarily go because people say, I ain't going to Cleveland. Why? Because the snow and ain't no market there. People go to L.A. Even if L.A. is terrible, people still go, if all else fails, at least I got sunny weather and I can get a dumb monster of endorsement money. So it's like, is it our fault that it's warm over there and people flock over there?
I mean, I guess that's the reason. I don't know why.
You know what I'm saying? Like, that's why players said it. That's why they take that into consideration.
But nowadays, it's not even, I don't even see it being like that much of a factor anymore.
I don't think
it's
being that simple.
I think it's about like the makeup now. Like, it's about the makeup of the teams now. Like, all they want to do now is just join star players together.
Because drafts aren't strong then. Like, back then, you had a draft where you had, you know, Marbury, Kobe, Iverson, you know, those type of players. The drafts aren't strong like that no more. So you have to go through free agency. The game has changed.
It's soft.
You know what I'm saying? So, and who started the softness? Jordan, which everybody praises. Yes.
Jordan was so relentless. The league started
when he couldn't beat the Pistons, they took away hand check, and that's how he got past the Pistons.
But the whole league was complaining. It wasn't just Jordan complaining about the Pistons.
Pistons was low-key
Karl Malone elbow.
Jumping people, bro.
The whole league was complaining about the Pistons. It wasn't just a
joke. That beard was so dirty.
Magic Johnson.
It was. I mean, I still feel like that's when the league was just better, though, to me.
I think so. 80s and 90s?
Like mid-90s, bro. Come on, bro.
Basketball was at its best. I agree. I miss it. That's probably why I'm not as interested in watching it.
But it's just that hunger. Like, certain players, you still see that they had that hunger. Like, Russell Westbrook, even though he flops just as much as LeBron sometimes, or just your any player, he has that. He has that savageness. I like that, man.
Yeah,
I like that.
They go beast mode with the
Clippers. See, but even LeBron, like, LeBron had this stint for like 2 years where he was like at his biggest. He was on Miami and he was just a savage. Like, he dunked on Jason Terry, and it was like, bro, like, he is a savage. And then he just gave it up. He just got slammed.
I mean, because
and wanted to play team ball. Like,
that's like saying, you know what? You're not as knowledgeable as me or a sneaker guru, so you're not as good as me. It's like, no. It's like, players are, that's what makes Magic great. What Jordan did makes Jordan great, because he doesn't have the same tenacity. When it mattered, he showed his behind against Detroit, and when he did game six against Boston, he's more about team. Kobe's a two guard, so the two guard's always been about getting shots and being about them, bro. What two guard was passive? There's no two guards. Reggie Miller, Jordan, Kobe, when Iverson was playing the two, all those guys have always been about getting shots up, and the shooting guards were the best player on the team. When you take a position like the small forward, which never really had an identity, and LeBron took it, it's like, well, I'm going to do whatever it takes to help teams, and then KD comes in with it, and Grant Hill gave you.
There's times in the game where you know, like, if LeBron would have just been LeBron, then they would have scored.
But then again, it's like, it's a lose-lose, because it's like, okay, LeBron, you didn't take the last shot in the game. Next 2 weeks later, games, Kobe would have made it.
But Kobe and Jordan wasn't worried about what people were saying about that last shot. Who took it? It was just about winning that game.
Even if you missed it, though, you still missed the shot. He missed it. That's why
Jordan got a commercial where he tell you how many shots he missed.
Sometimes his shot selection was, I mean, like, that one shot in game one, it was like, why are you doing a fadeaway three-pointer?
Because he won a game like that against Golden State before. So it's like, why not take that? What's the name? You know what I'm saying? So it's just,
look, I made a shot on the other side of my
house. I mean, then prime example, we went to the hole, we got fouled, never called it. And everybody say, so it's just like, it goes back to lose-lose. You can't.
I would just think like LeBron, I would think that he would think like, okay, I'm 6'8", 250 plus. I can jump out the gym. Like, I would just dunk on everybody in the post.
But you can't. The game's called now. Y'all just said it. It's touch fouls. You can't just drive no more. If you can just drive and just do what
that's
you want.
That's all Russell
Westbrook. He typically does, though.
But LeBron driving, he's going to get the foul. He's the star. Like, he's going to get the foul.
I think it's a
time.
Shock when he doesn't get the foul.
Yeah. That's why he always do the.
Yeah. I mean, he's genuinely shocked at the rest of America.
Yeah. Come on, man.
I
just want somebody to just come out and just stop being afraid to be that dominant player. Like, you so afraid to be called a ball hog and all that. Like, even KD need to do the same thing. Like, get some balls, bro. Just take over the game.
You like, still need your team. You still need your team, bro. Like, Kobe not a ball. He's a ball hog, but now look where it's gotten him to this point in his career.
Now, he a five-time champion and will go down as one of the greatest to ever play
the game. Okay.
Period.
And he won. Did he win those rings by himself?
Neither did Jordan.
I say that all the time. It's a team winning effort.
Neither did Jordan, but Kobe is one of the greatest players we will ever see, period. So it's like,
I mean, you need a team, but you need an engine. Like, you know, your car ain't shit without tires. True. You know what I'm saying? Like, you got a bomb engine in there. If you ain't got no tires, you ain't going nowhere.
True. Yeah, true.
So, I mean,
it goes hand in hand.
You know what I'm saying? So you need your parts.
True.
But, you know, you definitely need that engine. And if your engine stalls out, well, there goes the rest of your car. You ain't moving.
Right.
With that being said, got to get this thing moving. Release dates. We wasn't gonna do a shoot check today, but I'll wait till next week.
All right, we got Wednesday, July 22nd, the Nike Kyrie 1 Dungeon. All right, we got Jordan Son of Mars Hot Lava.
Oh, man, I hate that name. I do. It just annoys me because it's like lava's already hot. Like, why do we have to like wet water, cold ice?
Friday, July 24th, LC23 and Backdoor Special Edition of Puma R698. Saturday, July 25th, Air Jordan 1, 1.5, Chicago.
Other shoes.
Nike Air Max 95 OG Neon and his OG box. Reebok Question Low OG. Air Jordan Retro 7 GS Blue Dusk. Autonomous Special Edition A6 Gel Light 3, Birthday Dinner, Overseas Release Only. Comset Special Edition Nike SB Holy Grail Pack consists of both Nike SB Stefan Janowski Max and Nike SB Dunk High Stained Glass.
How y'all feel about those stained glass? I'm not feeling it.
I'm iffy.
I want to get some of these. I've been looking for Nike Air Prestos. Is anybody out there who can find me some Prestos? Please let me know.
Check that size out.
St. Alfred had them in Chicago when I was there.
Oh, I got to get the Thunderbolt.
What size you at?
Well, they come in like large, medium, large, like that, don't they? I would have to get a 12 in them. But I remember the Prestos when they came out like shirt sizes. So extra large was like from like a 10 to a 12 or something like that. But all
right.
I wear size 12 in those. Premier Special Edition. Oh, Nike Air Prestos Unholy Cumulus. Premier Special Edition Saucony Work Play Pack. Only 600 pairs available worldwide. Says Tidalo. Special Edition Reebok Ventilator Desert Dawn exclusively at Tidalo. When we going to get on Reebok Ventilator? Everybody else got one.
Well, it seems like they're giving it to everybody.
Nike 10, Nike Kobe 10 GS Laura Marion.
I ain't feeling those.
Air Jordan Retro 1 GS Maya Moore.
Took them long enough.
Yeah, she's been putting in work for a long time. Monday, July 27th, New Balance 577 Nate's Pack. Wednesday, July 29th, Nike Kobe 10 Elite Low Chester. I heard that was called the Rivalry. That's what I heard. I saw that. Thursday, July 30th, Nike LeBron 12 Low Bright Citrus. Friday, July 31st, Nike Field General 2. Raging Fire, Under Armour Curry 1 Golf, Nike Air Penny 6, University Red. Saturday, August 1st, the Air Jordan 11 IE Low White Cobalt. Got to get those.
Mm-hmm.
Nike Hyperdunk 2015's White Blacks. Nike KD8 Hunt's Heel Sunrise. I like those.
Nice, yeah.
Adidas Original ZX Flux Tech Fit OG Pack. And then Caesars Air Jordan 1, Air Jordan Westbrook 0, cool gray.
Yep, getting two of those, $800 for sale. The real ones come out the next day, too. Or the same day, I'm sorry.
Air Jordan Westbrook 0 red, Tuesday, August 4th. Nike Air Zoom Odyssey colorways from the Air Zoom 2015 collection. Wednesday, August 5th, Jordan Superfly 4, Marvin the Martian. Thursday, August 6th, Nike LeBron 12 Low Court Purple, Nike Air Max 2015 Neon. Friday, August 7th, Nike Air Field General 2 Ice Water. Saturday, August 8th, Air Jordan Retro 1 KO High OG Bread.
People going to be going crazy for them. Watch.
We still got the black and blue ones sitting. Air Jordan Retro 7 GS Future Flash, Nike KD8 GS Hyperbolt, Nike KD8 Lifestyle Black Gum. And then we got Wednesday, August 12th, Jordan Son of Mars.
Yep. I didn't name it like that. That's the name they had on it.
Easy. Poor guy. Well, shout out my man Kanye. They talking about you ain't influential. Friday, August 14th, Nike KD8 suit. Yeah,
look, Nike KD8 had a hot record.
Harper Cobalt. No, this is Kanye who had a hotter record than in the Philly.
Than Jordan?
Huh?
No.
Jordan and rap. August
15th.
Saturday, August 15th, Air Jordan Retro 7 Marvin the Martian.
Would never
real quick, dude make $100 million a year just for shoes.
Who?
Jordan.
Yeah.
That's stupid.
There would never be another figure
as right. That's why every time I hear he jumped over, I'm like,
never.
Ain't no way you
never. That but you
never.
But you still pick a Yeezy over a Jordan. It was on the table.
But how many Yeezys you have over your Jordans?
It was only six. I mean, did Nike give him more? Do
you got them all?
No, they were limited.
That's one reason why they so hyped up now. But on top of that, dude sell out like every Saturday. You make one shoe every other year. You jump
every Saturday.
And, I mean, it's not about the
and
it's not
or Wednesday
more.
For the last
like dude got his own company
20,
pretty much, like,
20 plus years. Like
hey,
we're
talking about the influence though. I'm talking about far as
he
color.
He got more influence.
I'm talking color. Well, why are you using the shoe? Why are you using his colorway on your shoes then? You can't say
he owns the color red,
bro. I didn't say I'm saying the colorway Yeezy. That's prime example. That's like if Kanye dropped some infrared Yeezy boots,
well,
infrared,
for one,
you would say
I'm not even sure that's Jordan Brand's name.
Yeah, Jordan
that
Brand
might be like
definitely didn't do that.
Yeah, that's like some
okay. Hey, of course
blog.
they're not gonna do it, but you know what? Nike has no way of sending subliminals. Like
I'm just saying, like I mean, Jordan Brand ain't influenced.
Who? I never said that, but there's the ones had the three soles on them. He's never denied his influence on, but you can't say, oh, this guy's influence on.
The influence is the whole signature shoe thing. And who made that?
That's
more,
what athletes, but right. They never gave a signature athlete his own shoe with Jay first person with it in 50. But I'm just saying, don't say he's not influential.
He's influential.
That's
what
I'm saying. Don't
he
I
is.
Never say he was bigger
well,
than Jordan.
No, he said he's bigger than. He said he jumped over the jump man.
And we talk about at that time, the releases, those Yeezys
no
were
time.
Hot.
I mean, he was hot, but that ain't that.
Bro, so if it was a Yeezy and a Jordan here, which one would you pick?
I'm picking a Jordan guy.
Yeah.
Have I ever come to your store looking for a Yeezy?
Because, you know, the price of it is too high, though. I mean, but it was rarely available, bro. Anyway.
How much money have I spent at your store? If I wanted a Yeezy, I'll get a Yeezy.
August 22nd, Air Jordan Retro 6 Low Chrome. And we got Air Jordan Retro 6 Low GS Sport Fuchsia. Friday, August 28th, Nike LeBron EXT Tennis Ball. Still no word on official release dates for the Under Armour Curry 1 Splash Party, the Mastermind Special Edition Reebok Insta Pump Fury.
Got you a nice little paragraph.
The Adidas D-Row 6 Christmas. If y'all got a release date, I don't think we should mention it.
Look like letting people know that it's supposed to be coming out. You want me to finish? I'll get it.
I'll finish it, bro. Adidas T-Mac 3 Pink. The Adidas Tubular X Red October, the Nike Foam Posit Pro Proof Platinum, the Nike Sock Dart Spring 2016 colorways, the Nike Dunk High Green Glow, then the Nike Flyknit Lunar 3 Electric Green.
Somebody driving somewhere.
The Nike Nike Free Innova, what's this? Innova Woven Mid, the Matte Silver, the Nike Air Max 95 South Beach, the Nike Air Force 1 Mid Cork, the Passport Special Edition Nike SB Blazer, the Nike KD8 and the Nike Sportswear Edition Lifestyle, the Nike Zoom 1 Vic Retro, the Nike LeBron 13, the Nike LeBron 12 Low, the Hyper Cobalt, the Air Jordan Future Low, Ghost Green, the Air Jordan 1 Retro 1 Mid, Lance Mountain, the Supreme Special Edition Air Jordan Retro 5 Collection, the Don C Special Edition Jordan 2, and the Air Jordan Retro 11 Red.
Let me get this. Also, there are a number of shoes releasing overseas with no set release date for here in the States, such as the Atmos Special Edition Asics Gel Light 3 Birthday Dinner. That's a dumb name. The Asics Gel Light Speed Great Camo. The Asics Gel Light 3 Gradient. The Titolo Special Edition Reebok Ventilator Desert Dawn. The Adidas ESM Energy Boost White Signal Green. The Nike Air Huarache Light FC Black Pink. The Nike Flyknit Roshe Run Premium Blue Photo Blue. The Nike Free Flyknit NSW Black White and Green Glow. Those are two different shoes. The Nike Flyknit Air Max Voltage Green, the Nike SB Dunk Low University Gold Black, the Nike SB Dunk High Blue Sky, horrible, the What the Nike Air Max 95, the Nike Air Huarache Sunset Glow, the Nike Kyrie 1 Rise, the Nike KD Tray 5 3 Rise, how many numbers they going to put in that shoe? The Nike LeBron Soldier 9 Rise, and the Nike Zoom Kobe Phenomenon 5 Rise. Stay tuned to SneakerPartyDetroit.com for more sneaker news and release dates. All right, y'all know what time it is. Let me get my music. Yep. All right, this is the Sneaker Box Lady Sneakerheads of the Week. Start off talking about the lady of the show, MJ, a.k.a. Lulu Shug. I am Miss T. Beautiful soul. Don't really get this name, but Ugly Melly. Miss Sneaker Junkie. Miss 8th Gen 910. Sea Dot. Dumb name. The Yellow One 78. This one sounds painful. Fire on my feet. Miss Texas Kicks, Lala 011, and a fan favorite of the show, Miss Jenkins 0070. These are the Sneaker Box Lady Sneakerheads of the Week. You guys know what to do. Got any lady sneakerheads you want us to shout out? Post them, tag them, tweet them. Make sure that you get their names to us somehow during the week. Shout outs real quick. Everybody knows, like Scully said, SneakerCon's coming in August 29th. Go to eventbrite.com, get your tickets. I think they're $25. Shout out my main man, Mike Rich. Follow him on Instagram at rich_mike23. Check out his YouTube channel, Rich's Kicks. What's up?
Nah, bro, I'm just Instagram with this Future Hive hashtag. They got the one where Future Sierra's holding her son saying, you want to, God blessing all the trap dudes, and you stuck at Bible class with her and your mama, her new man. Wow. They got another one where Jordan crossing Byron Russell and Jordan's Future and Byron Russell is Sierra.
They got one.
Oh, nah.
They got one where like the sky is like purple and blue and pink. And
they got one where
dead dudes in heaven listening to DS2.
It's got one where Russell Wilson is talking to Cam Chancellor and Bobby Wagner, and he's like, "I like Sierra Miss. I like Sierra Miss anyway. Get it, Sierra, my girl." His albums. Never mind. He was trying to crack a lame joke. Like they was just going.
Yeah.
It was like one has to go. And it was like Beast Mode, 56 Nights, Monster, and it was a picture of Sierra. Like
that's crazy. Check out my man Sherm Washington. Got a magazine on iTunes called Sneaks and Kicks. The OG Sean Paper Chaser Williams. Check out the OSD Live podcast. Also check his video From the Feet Up on Network A. Network A is YouTube channel. Juan Neal on his honeymoon right now. But check out his Loose Cannon Lifestyle clothing label. Go to www.shopLCLS.com to check out his selection of t-shirts and apparel. Also check out my main man Fresh Goods since 1985 on Instagram. Also check out the Detroit clothing line. Go to djbj3525.com. And check out their collection of apparel. Shout out to my man Chris Henderson of Sneaker Watch and Vlad TV. Check out his radio show, Mo Sports Talk, online or on the TuneIn radio app. You guys already know, go to sneakerbartytrade.com for all your sneaker news and the most up-to-date sneaker releases. Get all the pretty much everybody gets all the information from Sneaker Party Trade, even other blogs. And check out our sponsor, Greats Brand, by going to their website, greats.com, to find the best high-end casual and dress shoes without the high-end price tag. All right, so this is episode 46. How many more we think we can get to? Think we can get to 100?
Yeah.
We can make it?
Mm-hmm.
All right, so we're going to try to make it to 100. Definitely get some rest, handle some business. Hopefully I have a little bit more energy next show.
Yeah.
So we'll see you guys next week. We out.
Yo,
Red Rocket, get out! Carmen, what the hell are you doing? I'm milking the dog. They make dog milk.
No, they don't.
Yeah, just hold on a minute. The fifth grader showed us how to do it. Red Rocket, come on, dog. Red Rocket.
If you're not going to buy anything, get out.